3, 2, 1.
It's football time in East Texas, and the Carthage Bulldogs are ready to take the gridiron. The Dogs have been in the playoffs every year since 2008. 4 of those years, the Bulldogs were state champions. Can Coach Scott Surratt and his staff direct the Bulldogs to another state championship this year? Our broadcast is brought to you in part by ETMC Carthage, Prosperity Bank, Howell's AC, State Farm agent Tate Barber, and Pippin Motor Company. And you're listening to Carthage Bulldog Football on KGAS, your sports beat station for East Texas. Our broadcast is made possible again by these fine sponsors: the First State Bank and Trust Company, Bill's Meat Market, Carthage Furniture, the Longhorn Grill, and Panola National Bank. Be sure and tune in after the game for scores and stats by listening to EastTexasToday.com or go to the East Texas Scoreboard Show on 104.3 FM. And you can follow us on Facebook and Twitter at East Texas Sports Beat. Other sponsors making our broadcast possible include Fidelity Communications, Central Baptist Church of Carthage, XL Ford, Bauer Furniture Company, and Fire and Safety Equipment. Larry Allen is your play-by-play announcer tonight. Mark Harris will be providing the color, and Dustin Burns will have comments from the sidelines. Other sponsors making our broadcast possible include Farmer State Bank, Texas Farm Bureau, Carthage Automotive Tire Pro, as well as the Hudson Financial Group. Larry Allen is next with the starting lineup, but first, this word from Panola College.
Whether you're a recent high school graduate or headed back to school to finish your education, Panola College can get you on the right path to a successful career. Panola College offers degrees in a variety of programs, creating opportunities to excel your education. Make Panola your choice. Visit panola.edu.
Now, here's Larry Allen with the starting lineup.
Thanks very much, Jerry Hansen. Your broadcast crew from KGAS coming to you live tonight from Wildcat Stadium in Palestine, Texas. It's the Carthage Bulldogs and the Palestine Wildcats in a Class 4A Division 1 District 9 encounter. The fourth district game for both teams. Carthage comes in with a district mark of 2-1, and the Wildcats are 1-8 for the year and 0-3 in district play. Let's take a look, first of all, at that Bulldog offense. And it is anchored in the middle on the offensive line by Brandon Carlson. Carlson, a 5'11", 253-pound senior. The right guard is going to be Kedrick Henderson, 5'10", 300-pound senior. Left guard getting a start tonight, first start of the season, is Peyton Bickham. Bickham is a 6'1", 210-pound junior. The left tackle, who had an outstanding game last week against the Brownsboro Bears, is Kagan Baldry. Baldry, a 6'3", 240-pound senior. And the right tackle is Tanner Elliott. Elliott, a 6'3", 260-pound junior. Starting at tight end for the Bulldogs is Ford Parker. Parker, a 5'11 senior. And once again, that offensive line for the Bulldogs, Brandon Carlson is the center. Kedrick Henderson and Peyton Bickham are the guards. Kagan Baldry and Tanner Elliott are the tackles. And Ford Parker is the tight end. That's a look at the offensive line. We'll be back to take a look at the backfield for the Bulldogs offensively right after this break from your sports beat station for East Texas. That's KGAS.
Country at its best. That's our town motto. And part of what makes living here so good is having access to health care that rivals what's available in much bigger cities, because ETMC Carthage is right here in the heart of our community. ETMC Carthage, where emergencies are treated around the clock, and our Level 4 Trauma Center, where you'll find advanced radiology and imaging technology, specialist in cardiology, internal medicine, family medicine, and much more. It's personalized attention only found in close-knit communities like ours. ETMC Healthcare at its best right here in Carthage.
At Prosperity Bank, you're considered part of our family, so we offer a variety of checking accounts to suit any lifestyle, including a few with no minimum balance requirement. Need teen checking, mobile banking, or hassle-free debit card? Look no further than Prosperity Bank. And if you're in the market for a loan, such as a home equity loan or refinance, we're the bank to call. Your financial future is our focus. Prosperity Bank, member FDIC, equal housing lender. Go Bulldogs!
It may be hot one day and cold the next, but whatever Mother Nature throws our way, you can always count on a Train heating and cooling system. Hal and Bruce Whitaker at Hal's AC Heating and Electrical are the names to know to keep you in the comfort zone. Whether it's residential, commercial, industrial, or oil field work, Hal's AC Heating and Electrical is the one to call for service on all makes and models. 903-693-7451. That's 693-7451 for Hal's AC Heating and Electrical.
All right, let's take a look at the Bulldog backfield. Starting at quarterback is the Built Ford Tough Class 4A Player of the Week in the state of Texas for his play last week. That is Jared Blissett. He had 19 of 29 last week for 329 yards and five touchdowns for the season, 154 out of 260 for 2,137 yards, 19 touchdowns, and five have been picked off. So, again, Blissett, the Built Ford Tough Class 4A Player of the Week in Texas for his play last week against the Brownsboro Bears. He'll be backed up by Kason Davis, a 6'1", 170-pound junior. Incidentally, Blissett is a 6-foot, 232-pound senior. The fullback for Carthage is Brewster Griffith, 5'6", 170-pound junior. He'll be backed up by Kellen Foster, who is also a starting linebacker. He's a 5'10", 180-pound sophomore. The tailback is Ravodney Hardy. Hardy, 5'6", senior. And he has 116 carries this year, 641 yards, 5 TDs. And his backup will be Keontae Ingram, a 5'10", 180-pound sophomore. So once again, your starting quarterback is Jared Blissett. It'll be Brewster Griffith at fullback, and Ravodney Hardy is your tailback. We'll return to Wildcat Stadium in Palestine, Texas, right after this break from your sports beat station, KGAS.
We all like to save money, and State Farm can help with discounts. When you combine your car insurance with your State Farm homeowner's insurance, you get big savings. So talk to me, Agent Tate Barber, and experience the Good Neighbor service that has made us America's number one insurance company. Together, we can help you make sure you get the discount you deserve. No policy with State Farm? No problem. Call me, Agent Tate Barber, at 903-693-7555 or stop by my office, 1502 West Panola, directly across the street from McDonald's, to find out how much a multi-line discount can save you.
For more than 100 years, First State Bank and Trust Company has been a strong, trusted bank the people of Panola County can count on. Today, we are one of the few banks in East Texas to earn a 5-star rating for strength and security from the Premier National Rating Service. Bauer Financial has rated the bank one of the strongest and continues to do so year after year, good times or bad. We're proud of this honor, but are even more proud of the people we serve. To learn more, call, click, or come by. Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender.
There's nothing more pleasant than fall temperatures in East Texas. Evenings that are just right for grilling outdoors. At Bill's Meat Market, they make that outdoor cooking easy. Stop by today and find a 10-pound box of hamburger patties for just $29.99. They also have custom-cut steaks, delicious sausage, and a gourmet food selection. Bill's Meat Market, 1317 West Panola, where you can always find fresh-cut meat. Bill's Carthage.
Larry Allen, Mark Harris, Dustin Burns with you to live tonight from Wildcat Stadium in Palestine, Texas. And let's take a look now at the Bulldog wideouts for this ball game. And the leading receiver in East Texas is a Bulldog. That's Jakeldrick Jackson, 35 receptions, 749 yards, and 6 touchdowns. He's a 5'10", 170-pound senior. Not only is he the leading receiver, the second leading receiver is Marquise Gwynn, 6'3", 230, and he also is a senior. We'll also see at wideout Hunter Townsend, and you heard Coach Surratt say that for the first time in several ball games now, he is 100%, 5'10", 180-pound sophomore, 21 receptions, 349 yards, and 3 TDs. We'll also see Chris Attaway, 6'2", 150-pound junior, and we'll also see at times number 11, Roderick Callaway. And if you were at Chalk Talk, you heard Coach Surratt say that Roderick Callaway, a junior, is outstanding when the ball is in the air, adjusting to it and making a catch, sometimes a difficult catch. So once again, the starting wideouts for the Bulldogs will be Jakeldrick Jackson, Marquise Gwynn, and Hunter Townsend. We'll be back to take a look at the defense right after this from your sports beat station, KGAS.
Panola County football isn't shy. God says neither should we. The Apostle Paul encouraged his young friend Timothy, "For God did not give us the spirit of timidity, but a spirit of power and of love and of self-discipline." This is Steve Jackson, pastor of Central Baptist Church in Carthage. Share your weekend with us as we worship God and find strength for abundant life this Sunday morning at 10:45.
When you buy it in the morning, you will be enjoying it in the afternoon. Because at Carthage Furniture Company, you get delivery the same day. Monty Bacon specials include a sofa and love seat, the price just $6.99, and they are available in red, gray, or dark brown. Monty has two Ashley Rocker recliners for $2.99 each, or two Best Rocker recliners for $2.99 each. Just look through the car wash, and there we are, Carthage Furniture Company, where your comfort counts.
Longhorn Grill in Carthage, country cooking at its best. Stop by Longhorn Grill today and enjoy a country fried steak, catfish, shrimp, tilapia, or maybe even a cheeseburger. Longhorn Grill also serves up the best steak in town, and don't forget those mouth-watering desserts such as country peach cobbler and bourbon bread pudding. Open daily 10:30 a.m. until 10 p.m. with catering with to-go orders available. Longhorn Grill on West Panola, where it's all about the food.
All right, we return to Wildcat Stadium in Palestine, Texas, the scene of tonight's Class 4A Division 1 District 9 matchup between the Carthage Bulldogs and the Palestine Wildcats. Carthage, with a win tonight, would just about sew up the number 2 seed in the district. In fact, they will have the number 2 seed if they win and the Henderson Lions knock off the Chapel Hill Bulldogs tomorrow night. Well, we've looked at the offense. Let's look at the defense now. Starting at one end will be senior Jared McLean, 6'3", 215-pound senior, and he is committed to University of Texas at San Antonio. The other end is Trey Gatlin, 6'6", 220-pound junior. The nose tackle is Gilbert Perez, 5'11", 220-pound senior. And we're going to have a new starter tonight on the defensive line. Jalen Lewis is out for tonight. And starting in his place is going to be Mikael Gates, 6 foot, 218-pound sophomore. So Gates moving from the linebacker position to the defensive line. So once again, that defensive line will be Gatlin and McLean at ends. And in the middle, it'll be Gates and Gilbert Perez. All right, we'll take a look at the linebackers when Bulldog football returns on your sports beat station, KGAS.
Do you suffer from sleep problems? Sleep apnea is one of the largest growing disease processes nationwide. If you've tried to get help from a doctor or taken part in a sleep study only to find the mask is uncomfortable, then you need to call Cross Medical. Nationwide, about 50% of sleep apnea patients tolerate CPAP therapy, but Cross Medical's average is closer to 90%. Cross Medical staff are experts at fixing those little issues that prevent patients from compliance with therapy. Call Cross Medical, 903-938-2800.
At Panola National Bank, we're constantly looking for ways to make community banking even better. Now we're making it easier for you to bank on the go with Mobile PNB. Our new mobile banking service allows you to access your accounts directly from your cell phone so you can make transfers, check balances, and search transactions all from the convenience of your cell phone or tablet. Be sure to check out our new free mobile apps in the iTunes Store and the Google Play Store. Panola National Bank, member FDIC, and an equal housing lender.
Back. Time to dust off that backpack, sharpen your pencils, and save big on the most important tool of all, super fast internet. For a limited time, when you get Fidelity's high-speed internet with blazing fast 100 meg download speeds, we'll give you 200 channels of free TV for a year, or choose 20 meg internet for just $29.99 a month for a year. As always, there's no data caps, no contract, and free installation. Call your local Fidelity office today, or order online at fidelitycommunications.com/free TV.
All right, we've looked at the defensive line for the Bulldogs. Let's look at that group of linebackers. The weak side backer is going to be Brewster Griffith, 5'6", 180-pound junior. The middle backer is Kellen Foster. Foster for the Bulldogs is a sophomore. And the other backer over on the strong side is going to be D. Hearn. Hearn, a 5'8", 160-pound senior. So it's going to be Hearn, Foster, and Griffith, your linebackers tonight, going up against the Palestine Wildcats from Wildcat Stadium in Palestine, Texas. We'll take a look at the secondary right after this from your sports beat station, KGAS.
Hunting for your best deal on a new truck? We got you covered at Excel Ford in Carthage. We've got more than 50, you heard me, 50 new Ford F-150s on the lot and on sale right now. Regular cabs, crew cabs, 4x4s, work trucks, we've got them all and all priced low to go. Powerful performance, smooth ride, and huge savings. A Ford truck from Excel Ford delivers. No need to hunt around. You'll find us right on the loop and right on the price at Excel Ford in Carthage. Plus title, tax, and license with approved credit.
Bauer Furniture Company has been in Carthage for over 50 years, providing name brand furniture at affordable prices. Names like Lazy Boy, Mayo, and Serta are found at Bauer. Have you been in Bauer's lately? You will find a huge inventory, over 100 recliners, 70 sofas, 25 dining room suites, a store who takes pride in their community. Here on West Panola in Carthage.
This is Mark Harris at Farmer State Bank in Carthage. Did you know Farmer State Bank offers 15, 20, and 30-year fixed-rate mortgages? We will service your loan in-house, and you can make a payment at one of our five full-service locations, Center, Main Bank, and Rough Rider Branch, Carthage, Joaquin, Shelbyville. So come by Farmer State Bank, and let us help you buy the home of your dreams. Farmer State Bank, member FDIC, and equal housing lender. Money.
All right, we're back at Palestine. Here's a look at the secondary. And rather than give you the starters, I'm going to give you about six or seven players that we'll see in there tonight. Clark Newman, 5'10", 160-pound senior. He'll play some at a corner, as will Nick Moore, 5'9", 165, a junior. Also at a corner, we're going to see D. Bowens, 5'8", 140, a sophomore. And Mekhi Colbert, he's another sophomore, 5'8", 170. At the safety position, we'll see Jordan Romero, 5'10", 165, senior. We'll also see Mason Graham, 5'9", 160-pound junior. So some of the young men we'll see in the secondary, again, Clark Newman, Nick Moore, Mason Graham, Jordan Romero, D. Bowens, Mekhi Colbert. Those are some of the young men that we'll be looking at tonight here in Palestine as the Bulldogs go up against the Palestine Wildcats. We'll return to Wildcat Stadium after this message from KGAS.
Driving across Texas? Get comfortable. There's nearly 300,000 square miles to explore. In a state this big, you need auto coverage from someone who knows it all. Texas Farm Bureau Insurance, for coverage that's right for how and where you drive and every moment of every mile. Call us, because moments worth covering are never accidents.
For all your insurance needs, come see me, Jenny Morgan, out on the loop in Carthage at Panola County Farm Bureau.
Discounts may vary by situation.
At Winkler Place, senior living comes with care and service designed to make your life easier. And now, we're making it even easier to call Winkler Place home with a fall move-in special. Move in by the end of September and you can save on your monthly rental fee. Call 903-694-2525 today to learn how they can help you move in. Or just drop by to tour their apartment homes and see all they have to offer. Winkler Place is located at 513 North Adams Street in Carthage. So start packing. This offer ends soon.
Fire and Safety Equipment supports Bulldog football. Look for our new location at 2699 Southeast Loop in Carthage. Open now. We now offer digital fingerprinting, drug and alcohol compliance testing, along with our full line of PPE equipment. We have you covered from head to toe with the best brands, Ariat, Bulwark, Carhartt, Cinch, Wrangler, Rasco, and Walls. Check us out online at TexasFireAndSafety.com. Go Dogs!
All right, we return once again to Palestine, Texas, Wildcat Stadium, the home of the Palestine Wildcats. And I want to mention that tonight's starting lineup is made possible by Little Nut Oil Company, offering sit-go fuel with locations in Panola and Shelby County. You can always count on Little Nut Oil Company. Well, tonight is senior night here in Palestine. Next week will be senior night at Carthage Bulldog Stadium. And this is a significant game tonight. Not only will it pretty much wrap up the number two seed in the district for the Carthage Bulldogs, but if the Bulldogs win, this will be career victory number 100 for Scott Surrett at Carthage. His record in the pre-district games here at Carthage, 30-17. In district play, 38-3. In playoff games, 31-4. And you add all that up, 99 victories and 24 losses. And the statistic I really like, when you combine district and playoff games, the games that really count, 69-7 for the Carthage Bulldogs in the last 8-plus years under Scott Surratt. Well, I have a very special memory of Wildcat Stadium. I'll tell you about that later. Coming over today on the trip over here, Mark Harris told me about his memories of playing Palestine. Once again, my broadcast partner, Mark Harris.
Well, I'll tell you what, if you've never been to Palestine Stadium, if you've been to Lobo Stadium in Longview, it kind of reminds you a little bit of it because the press box is in the school. It's set up very well. This is an older stadium, but it's a really nice facility. Their whole school system's pretty good. I wonder sometimes why they don't have a good football team. But this year they're weak. They've only won one ball game. And this is the type of game you can't let down if you're trying to get a district a number two seed or a number one seed in district. When you play a team that hadn't won a game in district, you can't overlook them. They've got athleticism. They've got size that I can see. But, of course, they probably haven't run up on a team like us either. So, you know, you'd think when I played Palestine, they always had real good football teams. And I don't know what has happened since then. They have the size. I just don't know if they what they can't put together. So I'm sure Blissett, who's pretty much has managed every ball game very well for us. He's had some errant throws here and there, but as a whole, his passes have been on the money. This year we're catching them a lot better percentage than we did last year, and it's showing because of the way we play it. So we'll have probably a tough time tonight when you have a record like we have and you have a reputation for the last 9 years like we have. Everybody gets up for you. It's like when they play the Cowboys. People always play them better because they're supposedly America's team. So we're playing on Thursday night because of a rainstorm that's coming starting tomorrow, they say, and we didn't want to risk driving home in nasty weather. And plus you have also other problems when you have a rainy situation. You have lightning. And if it lightnings, you cannot start the game for 30 minutes after the last lightning strike from a monitor they keep up with. And we sat one night, I remember Larry and I and Dustin in Atlanta, and we didn't start the game, 11 o'clock, something like that. And we didn't want that to happen. So we'll have one extra day to prepare for our last game of the year. But y'all sit back and enjoy. I know a lot of people stayed home because of work tomorrow, and we hope the broadcast team can bring it to you and you can understand what's going on. We'll be back right after this.
Randy Hudson, a 1984 Carthage High School graduate, invites you to stop by their new Carthage branch of the Hudson Financial Group. They offer property and casualty insurance on an independent platform, which allows them to help you with all types of risk. With companies like the Hartford, Mass Mutual, and Travelers, to name a few, Randy and his dad, Herb, look forward to assisting you with your insurance and financial needs. The Hudson Financial Group, 1507 West Panola in Carthage. Call 903-693-7874.
Pippin Motor Company in Carthage is your authorized GM dealer in Panola County. You will find the best deals anywhere around on Chevrolet, Buick, and Cadillac cars, not to mention Chevrolet and GMC trucks. Pippin Motor Company has a state-of-the-art service department along with a well-trained staff to take care of your every service need. So whether it is sales, service, parts, or just a hot cup of coffee, we are Pippin Motor Company, located right across from Panola College, your full-service GM dealer.
The heat of summer has finally passed, and the next 2 months are a perfect time to get out and enjoy the outdoors. And there's no better place to do just that than Carthage Country Club, located on U.S. Highway 79 North. Carthage Country Club features a 9-hole course, driving range, and full-service bar, where you can relax after a round of golf. Memberships are available, and call about special seasonal pricing, 903-693-9900. Carthage Country Club, proud sponsors of the Carthage Bulldogs.
We're back at Wildcat Stadium in Palestine, Texas, and it's time now to give you the list of officials. It's brought to you by the Bulldog Stop, fuel for the car and food for the family. It's all found at the Bulldog Stop, and I tell you what, you know, every now and then you just see something new in high school football, and there's something new tonight. For the first time that I can recall, a 7-man officiating crew for a regular season game. I'm trying to remember what the size of the crew is normally for a playoff game, and I think it's normally 5. It certainly is 5 for regular season games, but we have a 7-man crew tonight here from the East Texas chapter, and according to the referee, it was the request of the two respective head coaches that we have a seven-man crew. The referee is Jim Cranford. Again, this is from the East Texas chapter. John Cannon is your umpire. Greg Aiken, the head linesman. Scott Hines is the line judge. Mike Riley, the back judge. Rick Myers is the side judge. And the field judge is Gaston DeBerry. So when you add that sixth and seventh man to the crew, it's the side judge and the field judge. All right, something I want to mention before we get underway here, and incidentally we are waiting the arrival of both teams on the field for the national anthem. The winners, or excuse me, the top four seeds from District 9, that's our district, will face the top four teams from District 10. Now let's take a look, first of all, at what Carthage still has remaining. Can Carthage finish as a number one seed? Yes, we still can. But to do that, we're going to have to win our last two, and Kilgore will have to lose their last two, and that's probably not going to happen. Can we still get a district championship? Yes, we can. To do that, we're going to have to win our last two, and Kilgore would have to lose one of their remaining two ball games. Well, and you heard Coach Surratt on the interview say that, in his opinion, Kilgore is better than the two teams that Kilgore has remaining, so that's probably not going to happen. So let's hope that we can finish up with a number two seed, and we can pretty much wrap it up tonight. In fact, if we do win and Henderson knocks off Chapel Hill tomorrow night, we will be the number two seed. Well, who will we play? We don't know, and probably won't know after tonight. In District 10, there's two teams that are out of it, Splendora and Cleveland, with 0-4 and 0-5 records. Little Cypress-Mauriceville is 2-3, and they're pretty much out of it, too. Jasper leads with a 4-0 record, and then you've got three teams in a logjam at second place. Huffman Hargrave at 3-1, Bridge City at 3-1, and Silsby at 3-1. One of the big games tonight is Jasper entertaining Huffman Hargrave, and I believe Coach Surratt said that Jasper also, who leading the district undefeated, they still also have to play Silsby. So we're going to know more after tonight, but we may not know who will we play in the first round of the playoffs until after play completed next week. Where will we play? Well, we definitely know that, just as was the case last year. Our district and District 10 have locked up Lufkin's Abe Martin Stadium for the first round of the playoff game week playoff games. All four games featuring districts 9 and 10 will be played there. One game on Thursday night, one on Friday night, and two on Saturday. And the way they determine that is the two district champions, they get the first pick of which nights they want. They usually choose Thursday night and Friday night. And then, so we're going to probably be looking at either Saturday, 1 o'clock or 7 o'clock. Last year we lost the flip. We wanted 1 o'clock and we lost it and got 7 o'clock. All right, the Carthage Bulldogs are out on the field in white uniforms with red numbers trimmed in black, and they wear a red helmet, and we're getting ready for the Palestine Wildcats. So we'll take one more break before we have the national anthem here and the coin toss from Palestine. You're listening to Carthage Bulldog Football on your sports beat station, KGAS.
Country at its best. That's our town motto. And part of what makes living here so good is having access to health care that rivals what's available in much bigger cities, because ETMC Carthage is right here in the heart of our community. ETMC Carthage, where emergencies are treated around the clock, and our Level 4 Trauma Center, where you'll find advanced radiology and imaging technology, specialists in cardiology, internal medicine, family medicine, and much more. It's personalized attention only found in close-knit communities like ours. ETMC Healthcare at its best right here in Carthage.
At Prosperity Bank, you're considered part of our family, so we offer a variety of checking accounts to suit any lifestyle, including a few with no minimum balance requirement. Need team checking, mobile banking, or hassle-free debit card? Look no further than Prosperity Bank. And if you're in the market for a loan, such as a home equity loan or refinance, we're the bank to call. Your financial future is our focus. Prosperity Bank, member FDIC, equal housing lender. Go Bulldogs.
All right, we're back at Wildcat Stadium here in Palestine, Texas. It is an artificial turf field here.
I heard it was donated by Adrian Peterson. I heard
it. Oh, all right.
Donated it. And I was going to go back to what you said a while ago about we still have a chance for a tie for district. When Henderson and Kilgore play, I don't care who's got the best team. You don't know who's going to win that ball game.
That's right.
And so, because they always play the last game of the year, and this is, and they're only 15, 20 minutes apart. So I can tell you right now, there's still a good shot that we would get a share of the district crown.
All right, do we have the Kilgore band mic'd? I bet we don't, do we, for the national anthem?
No, we don't.
Okay. All right, I tell you what, let's take another break, and we'll be back with a coin toss right after this from your sports beat station, KGAS.
It may be hot one day and cold the next, but whatever Mother Nature throws our way, you can always count on a Trane heating and cooling system. Howell and Bruce Whitaker at Howell's AC Heating and Electrical are the names to know to keep you in the comfort zone. Whether it's residential, commercial, industrial, or oil field work, Howell's AC Heating and Electrical is the one to call for service on all makes and models. 903-693-7451. That's 693-7451 for Howell's AC Heating and Electrical.
We all like to save money, and State Farm can help with discounts. When you combine your car insurance with your State Farm homeowner's insurance, you get big savings. So talk to me, Agent Tate Barber, and experience the Good Neighbor service that has made us America's number one insurance company. Together, we can help you make sure you get the discount you deserve. No policy with State Farm? No problem. Call me, Agent Tate Barber, at 903-693-7555 or stop by my office, 1502 West Panola, directly across the street from McDonald's, to find out how much a multi-line discount can save you.
All right, you know Mark mentioned that this game is being played on Thursday night because of the threat of rain on Friday night, and I tell you what, beautiful conditions here tonight. It's going to be 66 degrees here at kickoff, and the skies are crystal clear. So there's going to be great weather here tonight, and as Mark said, you know, with it being a Thursday night instead of Friday night, the crowd is going to be smaller. There's no doubt about that. It's smaller on the Carthage side. It's smaller on the Palestine side than we would normally have, but we're glad that you've joined us for Bulldog football. It's going to be time for the Copper Falls coin toss in just a moment. Copper Falls, where you can buy, sell, or trade your fine jewelry. It is an artificial turf field, and as Mark mentioned, it was contributed or made possible by Adrian Peterson. The word Wildcats is spelled out in purple on the south end of the stadium in the end zone, trimmed in white, and Wildcats also on the north end in purple, trimmed in white. We have four Bulldog captains out there. Make it three tonight. Make it four. Four. It's going to be Jared McLean, R.C. Rivadney Hardy, Gilbert Perez, and Jakeldrick Jackson. We will not get to hear the official, so we'll have to keep our eye on him. Two of the captains out there for the Palestine Wildcats. And again, the Bulldogs will have the number two seed, if we win our last two, or excuse me, if we win tonight and Henderson knocks off Chapel Hill. All right. The Palestine Wildcats have won the toss, and they're going to elect to take the football, and they'll be defending the south goal here. Tonight's first half kickoff is going to be made possible by the Carthage Sonic. Stop by the Carthage Sonic before or after the game and try the new boneless wings and six tantalizing flavors to choose from. Don't forget happy hour, half-price drinks every day from 2 to 4. Okay, let's check in quickly with Dustin Burns down on the sideline.
Can y'all hear me up there pretty good?
Sure can.
Trying out new mics. Yeah, it's first time we've ever been down this way to play a varsity football game. We were talking way over here last time I was here. It was in 1992 playing a freshman game. But I look for, Carthage to just keep the same momentum that they had last week against Brownsboro. We scored over 40 points. Look for the Dawgs to do that again tonight. Like to, see, the same passing game we had last week, but a little bit more run game. I think we need to, I mentioned that last week, have a good run game to get a little bit of confidence with our offensive line. We hadn't really ran the ball real good since about the first four games of the year, so we'll be on defense first. Hopefully we can set the tone. Hopefully we get enough points in this game. As Mark said, they're 1-8, not real good this year, and get some of these other second team kids, some of these JV kids.
Jose DeJulian. Jose DeJulian coming up from the junior varsity to kick tonight in the place of Rafael Hernandez. I'm sure Rafael is here with the team. Is he suited out? Do you see him? Okay. DeJulian with a strong leg himself. He's just a sophomore. Coach Surratt really excited about having him back for two more years. Here's the kick, and it is a end-over-end kick. It's going to be taken at the 8-yard line. Coming up from the middle of the 10, the 15, now right to the 20, 25, and he is pushed out of bounds at about the 27-yard line. It'll be Palestine first and 10 at their 27. That defensive line is going to have McLean and Gatlin at the ends. In the middle, it's going to be Gates in there for Jalen Lewis and also Gilbert Perez.
Darius Hearns on the tackle pushed the man out of bounds.
All right, so Palestine's going to have it first and 10 at the right hash. They'll be going from our right to left here at Wildcat Stadium here in the first quarter, which means they're headed toward the north end zone. This field does run north and south. There is an 8-lane track that surrounds the field, so it looks a lot like Bulldog Stadium. Larger seating capacity here. All right, snap back. It's a high snap, and the road ball is back inside the 10-yard line, and the quarterback falls on it back at the 7. It was a high snap on the shotgun formation, and that loss is going to go from the 27 back to the 7, a 20-yard loss.
Yeah, and that's how a 1-7 team sometimes will start out a situation. Maybe 10, what's going on with the reason they're not winning any ball games.
It looks like we got Pelham in there taking Jack. And Mikael Gates.
All right, let's see. It's now second down and 30. Second and 30 for Palestine after that 20-yard loss. In the shotgun, there's a snap. And they're going to the quarterback's going to keep it up the middle after a play-action fake to the running back. And he picks up about 5 yards out to the 12-yard line. Gain of 5.
I had seen some film of the Bulldogs. Like then, McClain was at middle linebacker. You know, he's usually our defensive end.
Okay.
And McHale's down, and of course you got Brewster out there. We must have a penalty.
Yeah, we were offside.
Okay.
Okay, so Carthage offside, which will make it first down now and make it second down, pardon me, second down in 25. Second down and 25 for Palestine. They took the opening kickoff, returned it to the 27, but then a snap over the quarterback's head on the first play from scrimmage in the shotgun, a 20-yard loss. All right, here's the handoff this time to a running back, and he bounces outside of the left to the 15 and has stopped at about the 18-yard line. We had him sort of bottled up inside, but then he bounced out to the left and picked up pretty good yardage from the 12 out to the 19-yard line. It'll be a gain of 7 yards.
It's Clark Newman on the tackle. But, yeah, he went into the middle of the line. And he's small. You can't see him. All of a sudden, he busted out to the outside to the left. And Clark came up from his safety position and put him on the ground.
Okay, we also got Brad West in there on the defensive line, 6 foot, 195-pound senior. So some defensive changes for the Bulldogs tonight because of some injuries. Okay, here's a snap back to the quarterback. Quarterback going over the middle. This ball is caught at the 28-yard line, and he is stopped at the 30. It will be a nice gain on the play of 11 yards, but it's still well short of the first down. It'll bring up fourth down and 7.
Yeah, that's a pretty good play. McClain was in the middle there throwing it. That's one reason, another weapon he is. He's so tall that he can jump in the air and make a quarterback think about how he's throwing the ball.
Yeah, you're right, Mark. He was playing like a male linebacker type.
So now nice bounce back by Palestine. They had first and 30, and it winds up being fourth and 7. They're going to kick the line of scrimmage is the 30-yard line, and we've got one man back deep standing back at our 38. Here's a rugby-style kick. He gets it off, headed toward the sideline, and it takes one hop, and in fact, it hits out of bounds at the Carthage 39-yard line. So that'll be 21 and 20. That's a 41-yard kick, but are we coming back? Yes, there's a flag back at the 29-yard line, back at the line of scrimmage.
Well, that's pretty good field position. It's on them. That's pretty good field position at the 39 to start your first drive. And it looks like he's going to, well, you can't tell.
Okay, Surratt's going to turn it down. So we turn down the 5-yard penalty against Palestine, and we will settle for the, let's see, it'll be an Alexley, a 20, and then
31.
Okay. Oh, they mark off the 5-yard penalty right there.
Okay.
Okay. So it would be 11 and 20. That's a 31-yard kick and a 5-yard penalty against Palestine as they mark it off from the spot where the ball went out of bounds on the punt. Okay. Here's the handoff to Hardy. Hardy left side to the 45, midfield 45. Almost broke it the entire distance. And that's another Garrett's Record Service Bulldog first down.
Yeah. Good run. Good offensive push by the big hogs up there. And we're already back to the line of scrimmage.
15 yards there for Hardy. First and 10 now at the Palestine 41. Ball is on the left hash as the Bulldogs go from our left to right here in the first quarter. We've got three receivers split out to the right and two to the left. So an empty backfield on this play for Jared Blissett. Five wideouts on this play. Snap back to Blissett. He looks right and throws right and looked like it went right through the hands of McLean at the 35-yard line.
It did, and he was trying to run before he caught it. You could tell he was already trying to pull his arms down. He had two defenders right there fixing to hit him. So it sets up a second down. We got 8:49 first quarter, no score.
All right, in this play, we're going to send Jackson and another receiver to the right, one to the left. Here's a play-action fake. Blissett rolling right. He throws. This ball is incomplete. That was a little high for McLean. We went back to him again after that first pass. Got both hands on that one. Couldn't hold it.
Yeah, and he really should have caught that one, too. He was in stride at that time. Wasn't standing still like he was the play before. He was rolling to his right, and it just went right through his hands again.
Third down and 10 after the two incomplete passes. And as Mark said, really both of them should have been caught by Jared McLean. Third down and 10 at the Palestine 41-yard line. Blissett, again, the built Ford Tough Class 4A Player of the Week from last week's. Snap back to him, looking over the middle. He throws over the middle. This ball is caught by Townsend to 23, and he's down at the 19-yard line at Garrett's Record Service Bulldog first down.
Yeah, and that's what Rat says in the pregame. We talked about this is the first game, really, that Hunter has been completely healthy. And so, and we really are kind of healthy going into the last part of the season, other than Jalen Lewis. We don't know what his injury is yet.
22-yard completion to Townsend. First down and 10 now for Carthage at the Palestine 19-yard line. Ball on the left hash. Bliss is going to go under center for this snap. Tight end left, wide out right. I mean, left goes motion right. That's Jackson. And here's the handoff to Hardy. Hardy over the right side, 15 to the 10. Hardy inside the 10 has another Garrett's Record Service Bulldog first down. First and goal at the 8 after 11 yards by Hardy.
Yes, he could. He had a big hole to run through. We had a guy pulling from left to right and open up the big hole for him.
Yeah, usually, you know, we talk about McLean, the two passes he missed. He's been on all year this year at tight end catching the ball, and they just wasn't able to get his big hands on those two passes there. Big run by Hardy.
Okay, so it's going to be McLean and D. Bowens to the right. Jackson and Gwynn split out to the left. So Hardy is in the backfield to the left of Blissett. Blissett in the shotgun. Snap back to him. He's looking right. He's throwing right into the end zone. This ball is caught for a touchdown. 8-yard touchdown score to Jared McLean.
Yeah, he got his big paws on that one. He's in the end zone. He knew he was going to get a TD out of that. And he ran a curl. He kind of curled towards the goalpost, and then he took back to the right. And the other receiver drug the defender out of the way, and he was wide open in the end zone.
All right, now the Bulldog extra point attempt brought to you by Pretty Paul's Grooming and Boarding. Carthage up by a touchdown, 7:36 to play in the first quarter. 8-yard touchdown pass to Jared McLean. And let's see, this is going to be, I guess that's Hernandez. Is that Hernandez in for the extra point?
It looks
like him. Low snap, great job by Kaysen Davis getting the snap down. And the kick is good.
No, that's 47.
That's 47. Okay, that's DeJulian on the kick. And it's 7-0 Carthage, 7:36 to play in the first quarter.
For more than 100 years, First State Bank and Trust Company has been a strong, trusted bank the people of Panola County can count on. Today, we are one of the few banks in East Texas to earn a 5-star rating for strength and security from the Premier National Rating Service. Bauer Financial has rated the bank one of the strongest and continues to do so year after year, good times or bad. We're proud of this honor, but are even more proud of the people we serve. To learn more, call, click, or come by. Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender.
There's nothing more pleasant than fall temperatures in East Texas. Evenings that are just right for grilling outdoors. At Bill's Meat Market, they make that outdoor cooking easy. Stop by today and find a 10-pound box of hamburger patties for just $29.99. They also have custom-cut steaks, delicious sausage, and a gourmet food selection. Bill's Meat Market, 1317 West Panola, where you can always find fresh-cut meat. Bill's Carthage.
All right, here's DeJulian kicking off, and it's going to be an end-over-end kick. That's going to be taken at the 10, going up the middle of the 15, the 20, and he will not make the 25-yard line. Good coverage down there by Cullen Foster, the sophomore linebacker.
Boy, he's got a nose for the football. They brought him up a couple of weeks ago, and because we had our injury to Mr. Brown, and he the first game he's a little iffy, but now he's getting where he's finding that football.
Okay, Dustin.
Can you hear me?
It's cutting in and out.
You may have to come on this side.
Okay, the Palestine Wildcats first and 10 now from their own 24. The ball is on the right hash. Carthage leading at 7-0 early here in the first quarter. In the shotgun, there's a snap, and the handoff goes no play action fake, and the quarterback keeps it going left to the 30. Nice fake across the 30 and out to about the 34-yard line. Going to be very close to a first down. Nice fake by the quarterback, that being Devontae Mims.
I don't know anybody home here on the outside. I guess he rushed to the inside, so he got the outside. He's in the flat. McLean came from the middle linebacker position to make the tackle.
So they pick up just over 9. We'll call it a 9-yard gain, so 2nd and 1 for the Wildcats at their 33-yard line, at the 33-and-a-half. Snap back to the quarterback, and he hands off to the running back going left, 35, and is out of bounds at the 40-yard line. That will be a first down, 7-yard pickup for Palestine. That's their first down of the ball game.
Yeah, and they're getting to the outside. We're going to have to stop that. Somebody's going to step up and turn that play in because he's getting to the outside and nobody's out there. 6:45 left in the first quarter, 7-0 Carthage.
All right, 1st and 10 now for Palestine at the Wildcat 40-yard line. Let's see, we've got Perez on that defensive line. Also, Marquise Gwynn is in there at a defensive end. First time I think we've seen him on defense this year. All right, snap back to the quarterback. He's going to throw right. It's caught out there. And here's a flag on the play, and the receiver is dropped for a loss of 2 at the 38-yard line. Remember, there is a flag.
There's a quick pass out there to the outside, and we manned it up pretty good. Let's see, that's 28. It was on the tackle. Keontae. They must have switched numbers. I don't know who 28 is.
Keontae Ingram.
Okay.
The sophomore running back. He mentioned that he might be in there on defense, too.
You know, Marquise played a little bit of defensive end like his sophomore year.
Well, that penalty, I did not see what it was for, but it's a 15-yarder against Palestine, and that takes it back to the 25-yard line. It's now first and 25. 1st and 25 for Palestine. So, boy, you can look at their first two series and see why they're 1-8. A snap in the shotgun over the quarterback's head on the very first play of the ball game, 20-yard loss and a 15-yard penalty right here.
Then there's another one. It's false start.
False start. That's going to send them back another 5.
6:14, 7-0 Carthage here in the first quarter.
So now it's going to be 1st and 30. 1st and 30. Remember, they had a 1st and 30 on their first possession. 1st and 30 for Palestine back at their 20-yard line. They've gone with two quarterbacks, Devontae Mims so far and Claude Rogers. Rogers a junior, Mims is a senior. And let's see who's going to be this time. It's going to be Claude Rogers. Rogers in the shotgun. He's got two wideouts to the right and one to the left. Snap back to Rogers. He rolls to the right from the shotgun. He's going to run with it and picks up about 4 to the 24-yard line.
Yeah, no Brewster Griffith out there on the tackle. Good tackle there. Brought him down as soon as he got to him. They are having a little success getting to the outside.
2nd down and 26. 2nd and 26 for Palestine at their own 24-yard line. Ball is on the right hash. 5:25 left to play in the first quarter. Carthage leading 7-0 here at Wildcat Stadium. Perfect clear skies here tonight. 66 degrees at kickoff. Rogers is the quarterback. Snap back to him in the shotgun. They're going to go with the screen pass. Screen pass caught is going to the left, and the Bulldogs with some great coverage there, stopping for a 1-yard loss back to the 23 on the screen pass.
Keontae Ingram on the tackle. But McLean was in pursuit.
So now it'll be 3rd down. 3rd down and 27. 3rd down and 27 for Palestine from their own 23-yard line. They've got to get out to midfield for a first down. 4:40 to play in the first quarter. Carthage leading here at Wildcat Stadium by a score of 7-0. This time it's going to be Rogers at quarterback. In the shotgun, twins to the right, one to the left. Here's Rogers looking right, throwing right. This ball is incomplete, almost picked off by one of the Bulldogs.
Keontae.
That was Keontae Ingram, okay?
you know, Keontae, you know, he's been running the ball for us, you know, some, and now he looks pretty good at a linebacker. He swatted that ball away from, and he was not in good coverage. He dove in there. 4:26 left first quarter, 7-0 Carthage.
So this would be their second punt of the ball game. First one was a 31-yarder. It's a rugby-style kicker. He stands back at his own 8-yard line, so a 15-yard drop. And here's a knee-high snap, no rush. He now gets it off, and this ball is going to be Jackson tried to come up with it, and it was off of Jackson, and Palestine has the recovery. Well, they've been telling our punt returners, make the catch, and a poor decision there by Jakeldrick Jackson. He signaled for the fair catch and then really didn't have a chance to get there. He tried to catch it on the short hop. He couldn't. And it is a turnover. Palestine has it at the Carthage 39.
And part of that problem is we had no rush on the kicker. So he rolled around there for a while and had all the coverage got down there in time. And so he threw his hand up like he's going to fair catch it. But also the kicker kicked it from the right side of the field to the left, and he was on the right, so he's running to catch it. It just didn't work out.
He was surrounded, as Mark said, by Wildcats. Incidentally, the Wildcats in gray pants tonight, maroon jerseys, a white helmet. And the quarterback this time is Mims. High snap to Mims. He's got it rolling to his right, throws downfield, and it's incomplete over the intended receiver's head at the Carthage 27-yard line.
That was Hearn's pressure on him, made him get rid of it before he wanted to, and because the man was open. He just overthrew him, and he was being rushed by D. Hearn.
Well, you heard Coach, here's a penalty on the play. This is a penalty. No, okay, we turned off. We declined the penalty. All right, the umpire started marking off a 5-yard penalty, and the head linesman over there next to the Carthage bench said, no, they declined it. So it is second and 10 for Palestine from the Carthage 39-yard line. And the quarterback this time is Mims. Mims, play action fake. He's going to run it himself up the middle, and nothing doing there. No gain for Mims.
And you notice then, Larry, we had people coming up from the outside and cut that play in. That's exactly – he had to go up the middle when he got right outside the tight end where he wanted to go to the outside.
All right, so it's going to be 3rd and 10 now. 3rd and 10 for Palestine. The ball right in the middle of the field with respect to the sidelines, and the way we know that is because it's right in front of the X that is on the 40-yard line. That's where they place the football for kickoffs. All right, so this time Rodgers is back in there as a quarterback. He'll take the shotgun snap. Again, 3rd and 10. Snap back to Rodgers. Rodgers looks right. Now he looks left. He throws left. This ball is almost incomplete, well over the intended receiver's head, and almost picked off by Makai Colbert.
Yeah, it went through. It was overthrown because we had a rush coming in. We had a cornerback coming from the outside, so he had to throw it early. And when he did, he overthrew his receiver, and it really – Colbert kind of got surprised. The ball got there quicker than he knew. 3:29 left, first quarter, 7-0 Carthage.
All right, 4th down now. 4th and 10 for Palestine. And in this spot right here, you got to go for it because at the 39-yard line, you're not going to gain much with a punt. Could go into the end zone for a touchback. So now here's Rodgers getting the shotgun snap. He throws to the left. It's caught there. And the receiver is going to be yanked out of bounds at about the 35-yard line. That's going to be a gain of about 4 yards. Not enough for the first down. They needed 10, so Carthage holds on downs and should take over at the Carthage 35.
And we were talking to the radio broadcaster for Palestine, and he told us that their best athlete, which is a punter and a linebacker and everything, that's why they didn't punt, because they don't have a good punter, is what he said.
He was injured early in the year there. Only victory was over Jacksonville early in the year. So Carthage takes over now at their own 35. Ball is going to be on the right hash as the Bulldogs start this possession. Carthage leading at 7-0, 3:23 left to play in the first. Bliss is going to take the snap in the shotgun with two receivers to the left and one to the right. He's got Ingram in the backfield with him. He's looking left, throws left. This is caught out there by Gwynn. Gwynn across 40, across the 45, and stopped at the 48-yard line. Another Garrett's record service Bulldog. First down after the 13-yard completion.
Yeah, Gwynn was lined up on the very outside. We had a slot receiver on the inside. He did a curl route, and when he turned around, Blissett had the ball right there.
So far, Blissett's gone to three different receivers, McLean, Townsend, and Gwynn. All right, Blissett under center now. Twins to the right and one to the left. Here's a handoff. It goes to Ingram. Ingram across midfield, 45-40. He breaks it. He may go to the 30, 25-20, 15-10. Ingram to the 5. Ingram, touchdown. And the Dogs have a 52-yard run by Cleante Ingram for a TD.
Well, and I like that because he's a sophomore, and he's not really got into a bunch of ball games. He was hurt with a hip injury at start of the year. And he's shown signs that he's got some speed, and it showed right then when he got past the linebackers. There's nobody could catch him.
Bulldog extra point attempt brought to you by Pretty Paws Grooming and Boarding. Kason Davis would be the holder, and Jose DeJulian is going to be the kicker. He's just a sophomore up from the JV team this week, for the first time. There's a great snap that time. The kick is away, and it is no good. He missed it. He missed that left upright. And the score here is going to be Carthage 13 and Palestine nothing. 3:02 to play in the first quarter. We'll be back from Wildcat Stadium right after this from your sports beat station, KGAS. Okay, well, I tell you, we'll keep it here this time. The Bulldogs scoring there on a 52-yard run by Keontae Ingram. And with 3:02 left to play in the first quarter, it's now Carthage 13 and Palestine nothing. The kick was wide left by DeJulian. Again, he is up from the JV team this week for the first time on the varsity, replacing Rafael Hernandez, who is not going to be playing tonight. But we think he's going to be okay, just being held out of tonight's ball game. The Bulldogs leading it by a couple of scores. The first score, if you were not with us, 8-yard touchdown pass from Jared Blissett to Jared McLean. And the second one, a 52-yard run right up the middle by Keontae Ingram. And the Bulldogs, again, with a victory tonight and a Henderson victory tomorrow night against Chapel Hill, would have the number 2 seed in District 9, 4A, Division 1. All right, here's the kickoff taken at the 7 up the middle to the 10, the 15, 20, 25, 30. Pretty good return. Coach Surratt won't be happy with that. Neither will Mike Borgen, the special teams coordinator, as the return is a 28-yard return from the 7 to the 35-yard line. Palestine with their best field position so far to start a drive. They're actually going to have it at 36. Larry Allen, Mark Harris, and Dustin Burns bringing you Carthage Bulldog football live from Palestine, Texas. This is Wildcat Stadium. Perfect football weather tonight here in Palestine. Skies are crystal clear. And the kickoff temperature was 66 degrees. All right, let's see who's going to be in quarterback now for the Wildcats. It's going to be Claude Rogers in there. There's a snap back to him. Rogers rolls to his left. Looks like he's going to run with the football. He's to the 35, to the 40, and is upended at the 41-yard line. And the tackle was made there by Mekhi Colbert. That'll be a gain from the 36 to the 42, a 6-yard gain that time for Mims. And we'll make it now 2nd down and 4. 2nd and 4 for Palestine at the Palestine 42-yard line. 2nd and 4. Ball this time is on the left hash. We've got 2:23 left to play in the first quarter with Carthage leading at 13-0. There is a shotgun snap this time to Rogers. Rogers with a play-action fake runs it up the middle across the 45, across midfield, and he's into Carthage territory, and that's going to be a first down. The line of scrimmage was the 42, and that's going to be a gain to the Carthage 49, so that's going to be a gain of 9 yards and will be a first down for the Palestine Wildcats, their 2nd first down of the ball game. Carthage, incidentally, has 6 first downs in the contest. So now 1st and 10 for Palestine at the Carthage 49. Snap back to Rogers. He throws left. It's caught there at midfield of the 45 and down to the 40-yard line, a gain of 9 yards on that pass play. And the Palestine Wildcats moving again from right to left here in the first quarter, which has a minute 35 left to go. Carthage leading by a score of 13 to nothing. It's 2nd and 1 now. 2nd and 1 for Palestine at the Carthage 40-yard line.
We apologize. We've had some technical difficulties, but we're back online now.
All right. So now here is the snapback in the shotgun to Mims. Mims, play-action fake, runs it up the middle, and he's across the 35 down to the 32-yard line, and that's going to be make it the 33, a gain of 7, and another first down for Palestine.
Yeah, they're moving the ball a little bit on this drive. I know y'all missed it at home, and They've moved the ball a pretty good distance. Been they're running that quarterback zone read, and that's always give us problems.
So now first and 10 for Palestine at the Carthage 33-yard line. Again, we're in the first quarter, under a minute to go, 53 seconds and counting here at Wildcat Stadium. Carthage leading at 13-0, but Palestine on the move. Snap back to Mims. Up the middle. And there's a fumble ball on the ground, and let's see who comes going to come up with it. They're going to say that he was down. He made contact with the ground, I should say. And that's going to be a gain of 3, 2nd and 7 for Palestine at the Carthage 30.
Yeah, we thought we was going to get on that, but he was down. His hip was on the ground when the ball came out. Got 21 seconds left in the quarter. We may not play another play. We're ahead 13-0.
It's going to be Mims taking the shotgun snap on this play right here. He does, and it's going to be Mims on a quarterback draw up the middle, and he picks up 1. To the 29-yard line, and that's going to be the end of the quarter. So Mims for 1, and that's the end of 1 with Carthage leading at 13-0. We'll be back from Palestine right after this.
Country at its best. That's our town motto. And part of what makes living here so good is having access to health care that rivals what's available in much bigger cities, because ETMC Carthage is right here in the heart of our community. ETMC Carthage, where emergencies are treated around the clock, and our Level 4 Trauma Center, where you'll find advanced radiology and imaging technology, specialist in cardiology, internal medicine, family medicine, and much more. It's personalized attention only found in close-knit communities like ours. ETMC Healthcare at its best right here in Carthage.
At Prosperity Bank, you're considered part of our family, so we offer a variety of checking accounts to suit any lifestyle, including a few with no minimum balance requirement. Need teen checking, mobile banking, or hassle-free debit card? Look no further than Prosperity Bank. And if you're in the market for a loan, such as a home equity loan or refinance, we're the bank to call. Your financial future is our focus. Prosperity Bank, member FDIC, equal housing lender. Go Bulldogs.
All right, the first quarter stats are made possible by Carthage Flower Shop on the square in Carthage. Carthage 6 first downs, Palestine 3 on the ground, Carthage 78, and Palestine has 33 yards through the air, Carthage 43, Palestine 23. All right, now it's 3rd down and 5 for Palestine. Here's a shotgun snap to Rogers. He rolls to his right and is now going to throw the ball out of bounds to avoid the sack at the last minute. And let's see what the call is going to be right there. It's going to be an incomplete pass, I guess. Okay.
Yeah, McLean made the tackle. He was running a full speed at him, and right when he went to throw it, he planted him on the ground. He was also forced out there by Gatlin. They were both on the prowl, and he was rolling to his right trying to find somebody, and we had pretty good coverage downfield.
So just before he went out of bounds to avoid the sack and a loss, short loss, he threw it out of bounds and avoids the sack. It's now 4th and 5. Here's a snap back to Rogers. Rogers throwing it right. This ball is caught at the 23-yard line, and he stopped at the 22, and that's going to be a first down. They needed about 5 yards, and they get 7. 1st and 10 for Palestine at the Carthage 21.
Newman and Colbert out there on the outside making the tackle. If our defender would have thrown his hands in the air, I believe he'd have knocked that down. He waited too late. We're just starting the second quarter, 13-0 Carthage.
So it's 1st and 10 now for Palestine at the Carthage 21. All right, the Wildcats up to the line of scrimmage. And the quarterback this time in the shotgun is going to be Mims, double tight end formation. They have some early movement that's going to be against Palestine. False start against the Wildcats. And, you wonder why a team is 1-8. That's their 4th penalty already for 30 yards.
And then a snap over the head.
That's correct.
That really hurt them.
That was the first play from scrimmage, a snap over the quarterback's head in the shotgun, a 20-yard loss. All right, so now it's 1st and 15 from the Carthage 26. Snap back to Mims. Mims keeps it himself across the 25, and basically he gets back the 5 yards they lost on the penalty. And it's now 2nd and 10 from the Carthage 21.
And he's just picking his way. I mean, that's pretty good yardage for a first down if you hadn't had a penalty. But he's doing that zone read and just following his blockers. It looks like he's got pretty good vision.
So that brings up 2nd and 11 now. 2nd and 10 make it from the Carthage 21-yard line early in the second quarter. 10:38 to go. Carthage leading 13-0. Mims in the shotgun. He's got the snap. And he hands off to the running back. Going to the left. He's to the 20. And then planted by Perez. Nice hard tackle there by Perez at the 18-yard line. A gain of 3.
Perez has been hurt most of the year. He's had a bad shoulder. And he looks like he's favored. He really put a hit on that young man then, and look like he's suffering himself. 10:13 left in the first half, 13-0 Carthage.
Boy, I tell you what, Gilbert Perez is someone that I admire. He is playing hurt, and he's just going to wait and have the repair done after the season is over. He's playing through some pretty tough pain. 3rd and 7 now for Palestine at the Carthage 18. In the shotgun, snap back to Rogers. He's throwing back over the left side, and it's intercepted by Colbert at the 6-yard line to the 10. 15, 20, breaks it to the 25, 30, 35, 40. And finally, down at the 43-yard line, Mekhi Colbert with the interception return of 33 yards.
That was Nick Moore.
Nick Moore, okay. My apologies.
That's all right. We got the ball. That's all that counts.
So, interception return by Nick Moore. Way to go, Nick.
Quarterback just threw the ball in the air, basically. He was being rushed and just threw it against the grain, too. And it was like a floating duck out there. Pretty good return, though, but Moore.
Moore, a junior, with the interception return. And that gives Carthage the football at the Bulldog 44-yard line. All right, we're going to have one receiver to the right and two to the left. Blissett in the shotgun. Snap back to Jared. Jared looking over the middle. He throws over the middle. This ball is incomplete, intended for Ford Parker. A little high, but looked like and a little bit maybe behind him as he had turned back a little bit, but had a chance to come up with it at the Palestine 36.
Well, the two that hit McLean were clearly should have been caught. That one, he was running down the hash marks, and the ball was thrown to the opposite side, so he had to turn to his left and just couldn't hardly get to it.
Y'all hear me now?
Yes.
All right. Good deal.
2nd and 10. 2nd and 10 now for Carthage at the Bulldog 44. Ball on the right hash. Blissett in the shotgun. Two receivers to the left, one to the right. Blissett now looking over the middle. He throws. Great catch by Jackson at the 40. 35, 30, 25, 20, 15, 10, 5. He's going to score. That's going to be a 56-yard touchdown pass from Blissett to Jakeldrick Jackson.
Yeah, he got the ball over the middle and just outrun everybody, to tell you the truth. He had some of them downfield. One guy he made a cut on right at the 10, 15-yard line and tried to tackle him. He pushed him off of him. So with 9:26 left, we go up ahead 19-0 here in Palestine.
All right, Jose DeJulian is going to attempt this extra point. The Bulldog extra point attempt brought to you by Pretty Paul's Grooming and Boarding. Jose DeJulian brought up from the JV squad. There's a good snap, the kick on the way, and it is good. And the lead is now Carthage 20 and Palestine nothing here at Wildcat Stadium. Bulldog football returns on your sports beat station, KGAS, right after this.
It may be hot one day and cold the next, but whatever Mother Nature throws our way, you can always count on a Trane heating and cooling system. Howell and Bruce Whitaker at Howell's AC Heating and Electrical are the names to know to keep you in the comfort zone. Whether it's residential, commercial, industrial, or oil field work, Howell's AC Heating and Electrical is the one to call for service on all makes and models. 903-693-7451. That's 693-7451 for Howell's AC Heating and Electrical.
We all like to save money, and State Farm can help with discounts. When you combine your car insurance with your State Farm homeowner's insurance, you get big savings. So talk to me, Agent Tate Barber, and experience the Good Neighbor service that has made us America's number one insurance company. Together, we can help you make sure you get the discount you deserve. No policy with State Farm? No problem. Call me, Agent Tate Barber, at 903-693-7555 or stop by my office, 1502 West Panola, directly across the street from McDonald's, to find out how much a multi-line discount can save you.
Okay, Dustin, we're going to go down to you. It's been a while because of the technical problems since we've heard from you. We'll go down to you right after this kickoff. 9:26 to play in the first half. Carthage up 20-0. Here's a kick by DeJulian, taken at the 11. Now up to the 15, the 20. The 25 flag on the play and stopped at the 25. We'll have to start out the flag. Okay, now down to Dustin.
What?
Okay. All right, 9:17 to go, and I tell you what, that was exactly where Coach Surratt likes to have the kickoffs go. If you go to Chalk Talk, you know that he'd love to have them deep and between the numbers and the hash mark, so it's sort of over on one side of the field, and that's where that one was. And let's see, the penalty is going to be marked off against the Palestine Wildcats. It goes back to the 16-yard line. And Palestine will have it there, first and 10. So that's going to be a 10-yard penalty. That is their fifth penalty for 40 yards tonight. All right, first and 10, Palestine at their own 16. This is going to be Mims getting the snap. Mims going to take it left. He was forced inside. Good stop there by Marquise Gwynn. And that's going to be a loss on the play back to the 12-yard line, a loss of four.
I tell you what, with these guys they bring it in here, McQuinn. We've got Gatlin, who's 6'6", and Quinn, he's probably 6'4". We've got some big, tall boys. McClellan's in the middle playing linebacker, 6'3". We've got some big kids out there right now.
So it's second and 14. Second and 14 for Palestine at their 12-yard line. Mims going to take the snap, and after the fake, he runs it up the middle, does Mims on the quarterback draw. And he's got some yardage there. It goes from the 12 out to the 23, a pickup of 11.
Yeah, he looked pretty good on that play. They had pretty good hold for him, and he wasn't hardly touched until he got tackled.
So now it's third down and four. Make it third and three. Third and three. The ball's on the 23, and they need to get to the 26 for a first down. Incidentally, Palestine with four first downs in the ball game. Carthage now has eight. Third down and three for Palestine. Ball a couple of yards to the right of the left hash. Here's the quarterback rolling to his right. Rodgers throws, and this ball is caught for a first down out at the 30-yard line. Pickup of seven.
He rolled out there far enough and had bought himself enough time to get a man open in the flat.
So it's first and 10, Palestine at the Palestine. Okay, we'll call it the 29-yard line, a gain of six on that play. We've got 7:48 to play in the half. Carthage up 20-0 here at Wildcat Stadium. Glad you could join us for Carthage Bulldog football on KGAS on a Thursday night. All right, Claude Rogers is going to take the snap in the shotgun. He's got it. Hands off to the running back up the middle, and he's got about three or four. We'll call it from the 29 to the 33, a pickup of four.
You know, I don't guess we've ever done a game on Thursday night, every Larry that I remember. And, you know, Gilmer plays a lot of Thursday night games. A lot of people play some Thursday night games, and ones in Dallas have to because they have to share the field.
Correct, and, you know, sometimes in Tyler you've got to share the field, too, between Tyler Lee and John Tyler. But as Mark said, especially in Dallas where you've got multiple teams playing on at one stadium. Okay, the snap this time is going to go back to Claude Rogers. Rogers hands off the running back, has a big hole, 35-40. He breaks it. He's going to score. He's to the 30, 25-20, 15-10, 5, and that's going to be a touchdown run of 67 yards, and let's catch who that number is for the Palestine Wildcats. I believe that's number four, and that would be Eric Dion.
He just ran off everything we had. When he got past us, we couldn't even think about catching him.
67-yard touchdown run by Eric Dion.
Next score, 20-6.
And we will have the extra point attempt coming up now. There's a snap. Good snap. The kick on the way, and it is good. And the score is Carthage 20 and Palestine 7. 6:51 to play in the first half. Back right after this.
For more than 100 years, First State Bank and Trust Company has been a strong, trusted bank the people of Panola County can count on. Today, we are one of the few banks in East Texas to earn a 5-star rating for strength and security from the Premier National Rating Service. Bauer Financial has rated the bank one of the strongest and continues to do so year after year, good times or bad. We're proud of this honor, but are even more proud of the people we serve. To learn more, call, click, or come by. Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender.
There's nothing more pleasant than fall temperatures in East Texas. Evenings that are just right for grilling outdoors. At Bill's Meat Market, they make that outdoor cooking easy. Stop by today and find a 10-pound box of hamburger patties for just $29.99. They also have custom-cut steaks, delicious sausage, and a gourmet food selection. Bill's Meat Market, 1317 West Panola, where you can always find fresh-cut meat. Bill's Carthage.
All right, Palestine getting on the board, a 67-yard run by Eric Dion, and it's now 20-7. Carthage leading by 13 points or two scores, 6:51 left to play in the half. And we're going to try Dustin again here in just a second. Had some problems making contact with him. Here's a kick going toward the sideline, taken at the 17-yard line to the 20, 25, 30. And that's going to be a return back to the 33. That is Makai Colbert. There's no doubt about it on this return. Okay, Dustin, can you hear us? Okay, well.
He just needs to come on this side of the field. He can talk to us. 6:46 left, 20-7. Carthage is ahead here in the first half.
So here come the Bulldogs out on the field. Again, leading by 13. A Bulldog win tonight and a Henderson win tomorrow night against Chapel Hill. And Carthage will be the number two seed out of District 9, Class 4A Division 1. All right, here's the snap to Hunter Townsend. Townsend to the 35, out to the 40. So Townsend taking the shotgun snap and goes for 7 yards out to the Carthage 40-yard line.
Yes, we need he's back healthy tonight. I'm wanting to see him catch a long pass from Blissett on the run. That's what I want to see.
Blissett, incidentally, has gone to four different receivers tonight. Jackson for 56, McLean 8, Townsend 22, and Gwynn 13-yard reception. All right, Blissett under center. Blissett, three-step drop, pump fake left. Now going deep down the left sideline to Bowens. He's got it to 30, and he's down to the 25-yard line, a pump fake left, and that got Bowens the opportunity to get open. Wait a minute, though. We've got the ball coming back. It's going to be a false start against Carthage. Well, that's going to wipe out a beautiful pass from Blissett to D. Bowens. Great fake there, a pump fake on the left side, and then he hit Bowens down the left sideline. But it's coming back. False start.
I tell you what, that Bowens, he's going to be something special. He, and the way he caught that ball, too, if you notice, he popped those, put both of his hands out there like your receiver's supposed to catch them. He's going to make some plays for us.
Yes, he's a playmaker. There's no doubt about it. And Bowens, again, just a sophomore and a little bitty fella, too. Not very large at all. He splits out to the left and two receivers out to the right. It's now second and 8 after the penalty. Here's a throw to the right side. Almost picked off, but it's caught by Jackson to the 40, 45 midfield. He may go 40, 35, 30, 25, 20, 15, 10, 5, touchdown. Palestine went for the interception. They didn't get it. And Jakeldrick Jackson makes it a 65-yard touchdown reception for the Bulldogs. 65 yards on the touchdown reception for Jakeldrick Jackson. Palestine had seen that play before, obviously on film, and they went for the interception. And when he didn't come up with it, when he didn't deflect it, then Jackson took it and made a great run down the far sideline in front of the Carthage bench. 65 yards, and it's now 26-7 Dogs, 5:38 to play here in the first half. Okay, DeJulian for the extra point. There's a snap. The kick is partially blocked, it appeared. It was blocked, and so it's no good, and Carthage leads it 26-7 with 5:38 to play in the second quarter. Back from Palestine right after this. Okay, 65-yard pass, and again that went from Jared Blissett to Jakeldrick Jackson. And so let me update this. Let me update these numbers here now. Let's see. That was a 65-yard pass, and Jackson now has got 121 yards receiving. Another touchdown for the Bulldogs, or no, the first down, excuse me. That's their ninth of the ball game. And kicking off now will be DeJulian. DeJulian kicking off. Jose DeJulian. And he's getting ready to kick off. And here is the kick. And it is an end-over-end kick coming toward the sideline. And it's taken. No, it's muffed by Palestine. They go back, pick it up at the 7. Now he's trying to go left. Now comes up the middle to the 15, 20, 25. And finally stopped at the 27-yard line. He took that one just before going out of bounds, muffed it. He caught it, or tried to catch it about the 10. It went back. He picked it up at the 7 and made a pretty good return out to his own 27-yard line, where Palestine will have it now first and 10. 5:28 left to play in the first half. 5:28 left to play in the first half. Carthage leading Palestine by a score of 26-7. All right, now the Wildcats with it. Now let's see, were we off the air for a while?
You were off the air for a while.
We are off still?
No.
No, we are on now. Okay, Palestine with the football. We'll tell you what you may have missed, a 65-yard pass from Blissett to Jakeldrick Jackson. The kick was partially blocked. It was blocked by the Wildcats, and now Palestine with the football. And on first and 10 from their own 27-yard line, they pick up 1 yard.
Well, how many yards has Blissett thrown so far tonight?
He's got 164 now.
Okay, in the first half. That's good.
All right, second and 9 now for Palestine at their own 28. Snap back to Rogers in the shotgun. Rogers with a play-action fake, going to keep it himself around the right end. Across the 30, the 35, and he is pushed out of bounds at the 36-yard line, and that's going to be short of the first down marker. He picks up about 8 yards on that, and it'll bring up third down and 1.
We had a linebacker, had him at the line of scrimmage, and he just stiff-armed him out of the way. 4:45 left, 26-7 Carthage here in the first half. We've been dropping in and out of our phone coverage, and so that's why you're missing some of the ball game.
Third down and 1. Third and 1 for Palestine at their own 26-yard line. Snap back down this time to Mims. Mims up the middle with it after the fake. And Mims, with a tough run, is finally brought down at the 45-yard line. That's going to be a gain on the play of 9 yards and a first down.
Yeah, it reminded us when we played Kilgore, we'd have one of those guys in the back behind the line of scrimmage, and they're just – gutsy, and then he drug four or five ball players right there for the good yardage.
4:30 left to play in the first half. Carthage leading over Palestine 26-7. Incidentally, we'll mention again, if Carthage wins this, it would be the 100th career victory at Carthage for head coach Scott Surratt. Okay, here's the handoff to a running back, and that's going to be Dion, I believe, across midfield, and he has the Carthage 48-yard line, a gain of 7 for Dion.
McLean on tackle with Brewster. 4 minutes left in the first half, 26-7 Carthage.
Second and three for Palestine at the Carthage 48-yard line. Bulldogs 5-3 for the season, 2-1 in district play coming into the ball game. Second and three for Palestine at the Carthage 48. Flag on the play, false start against Palestine.
Palestine just shoots herself in the foot. You can tell it. I mean, they've got some pretty good athletes. The one that broke the run a while ago was faster than everybody we had. They got some big old offensive linemen. They just make bad mistakes.
So that mistake, a 5-yard penalty, moves it back to the Palestine 47. It's now 2nd and 8, 3:25 left to play in the first half. Carthage leading 26-7 here at Wildcat Stadium. Snap back to Mims. Mims going to keep it himself. Gets away from a tackler at the 45-yard line. He's across the midfield. We had him at the 45, missed a tackle. He picks up 6 more yards after that, and it's going to be a net gain on the play, let's see, of about 5 yards. Okay, so we had him initially for a loss, and he winds up picking up 5.
Yeah, we had him. McLean's the one that had him. He got away from him. You know, he can't hardly get away from McLean, but he's a tough runner. Not a big guy, but tough.
Third and three for Palestine now at the Carthage 48. 2:40 to play in the half. Carthage leading 26-7. And here's a snap back. It goes to Mims again after the fake. He's going to take it up the middle. And he picks up another first down. That's going to be a gain of another 6 yards for Mims. He's now got 38 yards on 13 carries. And another first down. That's their eighth first down.
Well, we're scoring so fast, we're not getting first downs, you know. So that's going to be kind of deceiving. We scored on 260-something yard passes in a long run.
All right, now we're down to 210 and counting in the first half. Carthage leading 26-7. First and 10 Palestine at the Carthage 42. And here's Dion, who scored on the long run, and he is not going to get back to the line of scrimmage there. It's going to be a one-yard loss back to the 43 as about four or five Bulldogs wrap him up.
They tried to get to the outside that time, but we weren't fooled on that. We had plenty of people out there to stop that. They've had better luck. They started out having good luck on the outside. Now they've been having real good luck going up the middle.
Second and 11. Second and 11 for Palestine at the Carthage 43. Minute 30 to go. 90 seconds to go here in the half. Snap back to Mims. Mims hands off to Dion. Dion going left to the 40. And then is knocked down there at the 39-yard line. Let's see. Was there a turnover? Yes, there was. Carthage with the recovery. There's a Palestine turnover at the Carthage 40, or make it 39-yard line. Carthage football.
Somebody really hit him. I couldn't tell from the outside. And Dustin's, we can't get to him tonight. So I couldn't tell who it is. But there's some discussion going on over there. Is somebody still down or?
It's a timeout.
Timeout? All right.
Panola County football isn't shy, and God says neither should we. The Apostle Paul encouraged his young friend Timothy, "For God did not give us the spirit of timidity, but a spirit of power and of love and of self-discipline." This is Steve Jackson, pastor of Central Baptist Church in Carthage. Share your weekend with us as we worship God and find strength for abundant life this Sunday morning at 10:45.
It's
okay.
It's still their ball.
It's still their ball. Okay. Well, all right.
I thought they
signaled that.
They did.
They did, didn't they?
They did signal that it was our ball.
Okay. All right. We'll wipe that out then. No turnover. It's now third down. Third down and about seven for Palestine from the 39-yard line. Here's a play-action fake. Rogers rolling to his right. He wanted to throw it, and he is almost sacked by McLean. And to avoid the sack, he unloads it at the last second, and it's an incomplete pass. McLean all over him. In fact, he had him and was taking him down to the turf as he released the pass.
1:12 left in the first half, 26-7 Carthage. And Palestine does call a timeout. This is KGAS. We'll be back after this.
When you buy it in the morning, you will be enjoying it in the afternoon. Because at Carthage Furniture Company, you get delivery the same day. Monty Bacon specials include a sofa and love seat, the price just $6.99, and they are available in red, gray, or dark brown. Monty has two Ashley Rocker recliners for $2.99 each, or two Best Rocker recliners for $2.99 each. Just look through the car wash, and there we are, Carthage Furniture Company, where your comfort counts.
Longhorn Grill in Carthage, country cooking at its best. Stop by Longhorn Grill today and enjoy a country fried steak, catfish, shrimp, tilapia, or maybe even a cheeseburger. Longhorn Grill also serves up the best steak in town, and don't forget those mouth-watering desserts such as country peach cobbler and bourbon bread pudding. Open daily 10:30 a.m. until 10 p.m. with catering and to-go orders available. Longhorn Grill on West Panola, where it's all about the food.
All right, the score is Carthage 26, Palestine 7, 1:12 to play in the first half. Okay, let's try Dustin again. Dustin, can you hear us? Fourth down for Palestine, fourth and six for Palestine at the Carthage 38-yard line. Let's see what Palestine calls after the timeout. Claude Rogers is going to take the snap. He's got it. He's looking to the right. Now he's going to try to run with it, and he's going to be sacked. That will be an official sack. That will be a loss from the 38 to the 44, a loss of six, and Carthage takes over at their own 44, a minute five to go.
Man, that had every one of the Carthage linemen back here. All four of them were back there converging on the tackle.
So now let's see. We've got a minute five to go and two timeouts from our 44-yard line. And if you've watched football with under the Bulldog football the last 9 years with Scott Surratt, you know that that is plenty of time to score if the Bulldogs, you know, just hit the right pass right here. Probably going to be throwing it. We'll wait and see. Bulldogs with 85 yards on the ground. Two big running plays accounting for most of that. All right, snap back to Blissett. Play action fake. He throws it left to Gwynn. Gwynn to the 45, and he's out of bounds. Got out of bounds quickly when he saw he couldn't get much, and that's going to be a gain of 4 to the 48.
A minute left now in half, 26-7 Carthage.
Second reception for Gwynn for a total now of 17 yards. Blissett in the shotgun now, second and six at their 48, the Bulldog 48. Here's Blinn looking right. It's caught by Jackson. And let's see, Jackson's going to be short of the first down marker. It goes from the 48 to the Palestine 48, a gain of four more.
They're back to the line of scrimmage.
And Blissett now in the shotgun, gets a snap, throws right. It's caught by Jackson, the 45, 40, 35, 30. 25, and that's going to be a Garrett's record service Bulldog first down. It goes from the 48, and let's see where they spot that one.
We spotted on
about the 22-yard line. Okay, we'll call that a 26-yard pass. 26 yards to Jackson. Bulldog first down. Garrett's record service Bulldog first down at the 22. Make it the 23. Here's pump fake right and wide open at the goal line, and overthrown is Hunter Townsend.
No, he should have caught that. He kind of pulled up.
Did he pull up there?
That ball was thrown pretty well, I thought.
It was pump fake to the right, and then Townsend got well beyond the secondary, and that pass is incomplete. So that makes it now second down and 10. Second and 10 from the 23. Snap back to Blissett. Blissett going to go with a screen to the right side. Caught there by Hardy. Hardy to the 20. Hardy to the 15. To the 10. Hardy down to inside the 5. Hardy out of bounds at the 3. Another Garrett's record service Bulldog first down at the 3-yard line, first and goal.
That screen pass this year is working very well. We've run it just about every game. And Hardy gets positive yards just about every time. And then when he's a load, when he gets down those small defensive backs trying to tackle him, he had three or four Wildcats hanging from him and went out of bounds.
Okay, we'll call that down at the 2-yard line.
We have timeouts left.
And so first and goal for Carthage at the 2, 17 seconds to go, two timeouts left in the half here. Blissett under center. Blissett handoff Hardy. Hardy up the middle, untouched into the end zone. Two-yard touchdown run for Vervodny Hardy. And that's going to up the score now to 32-7, Carthage.
Just a simple dive to the left side, and they couldn't stop him. Dustin, if you can hear us, you can try that mic over here at halftime for the band. You're coming in occasionally.
All right, let's see what the Bulldogs do now, leading 32-7. And we've got a flag on the play. It's going to be a substitution penalty. Scott Surratt asking for an explanation.
13 seconds left, 32-7. We're trying to get an extra point here. We're going to go for two, looks like. And they're going to march us back, so I don't know if we're still going to go for two or not. Our kicking game hadn't been real good. Our kicker, I guess he's injured. Is that what it is?
I think so. Rafael Hernandez is out for the ball game. Okay, Callaway in as a wide out to the right. McClinn to the left. Here's Blissett. Blissett, two-step drop, goes into the end zone and is caught by McClinn over the shorter defender for the two-point conversion pass, and it's now 34-7 Carthage.
Perfect.
That was a pretty
fade.
Pause, grooming, extra point.
That was a pretty fade right there. He led him just right. Blissett's thrown the ball very well tonight. 34-7. We'll be back after this.
Do you suffer from sleep problems? Sleep apnea is one of the largest growing disease processes nationwide. If you've tried to get help from a doctor or taken part in a sleep study only to find the mask is uncomfortable, then you need to call Cross Medical. Nationwide, about 50% of sleep apnea patients tolerate CPAP therapy, but Cross Medical's average is closer to 90%. Cross Medical staff are experts at fixing those little issues that prevent patients from compliance with therapy. Call Cross Medical, 903-938-2800.
At Panola National Bank, we're constantly looking for ways to make community banking even better. Now we're making it easier for you to bank on the go with Mobile PNB. Our new mobile banking service allows you to access your accounts directly from your cell phone so you can make transfers, check balances, and search transactions all from the convenience of your cell phone or tablet. Be sure to check out our new free mobile apps in the iTunes Store and the Google Play Store. Panola National Bank, member FDIC, and an equal housing lender.
All right, here's the kickoff taken by Palestine back at the 9. They come out to the 10, the 15, 20, 25, and he is pushed out of bounds at about the 30-yard line. Here's a flag coming in.
Face mask on Palestine, huh?
He must have
shoved off as he went out of bounds.
5 seconds to go in the half. It was returned to the 28.
How many penalties have they had, Larry? Now, Palestine.
Let's see. If that's against them, that will be seven.
Seven. And a bunch of yardage.
And this is going to be for 14 yards. So it's going to be seven for 59 yards. Carthage 2 for 10. That's just one indication, you know, of why a team is 1-8. Palestine 1-8 for the year. Their only victory over Jacksonville very early in the season. I'm thinking it may have been the first game of the year, so I think they've lost 8 in a row, and they're 0-3 in district play. Carthage 2-1 in district play, 6-5-3 make it for the year. And here's a handoff, and this is going to go to Dion. And Dion on the final play of the half is going to be stopped at the 20-yard line. And that will be a gain of 6 yards, and that'll end the half. Carthage leading at 34-7 here in Palestine.
School's back. Time to dust off that backpack, sharpen your pencils, and save big on the most important tool of all, super fast internet. For a limited time, when you get Fidelity's high-speed internet with blazing fast 100 meg download speeds, we'll give you 200 channels of free TV for a year. Or choose 20 meg internet for just $29.99 a month for a year. As always, there's no data caps, no contract, and free installation. Call your local Fidelity office today or order online at fidelitycommunications.com/free TV.
Hunting for your best deal on a new truck? We got you covered at Excel Ford in Carthage. We've got more than 50, you heard me, 50 new Ford F-150s on the lot and on sale right now. Regular cabs, crew cabs, 4x4s, work trucks, we've got them all and all priced low to go. Powerful performance, smooth ride, and huge savings. A Ford truck from Excel Ford delivers. No need to hunt around. You'll find us right on the loop and right on the price at Excel Ford in Carthage. Plus title, tax, and license with approved credit.
Bauer Furniture Company has been in Carthage for over 50 years, providing name brand furniture at affordable prices. Names like Lazy Boy, Mayo, and Serta are found at Bauer. Have you been in Bauer's lately? You will find a huge inventory, over 100 recliners, 70 sofas, 25 dining room suites, a store who takes pride in their community. Here on West Panola in Carthage.
This is Mark Harris at Farmers State Bank in Carthage. Did you know Farmers State Bank offers 15, 20, and 30-year fixed-rate mortgages? We will service your loan in-house, and you can make a payment at one of our 5 full-service locations, Center, Main Bank, and Rough Rider Branch, Carthage, Joaquin, Shelbyville. So come by Farmers State Bank, and let us help you buy the home of your dreams. Farmers State Bank, member FDIC, and equal housing lender. Money.
Driving across Texas? Get comfortable. There's nearly 300,000 square miles to explore. In a state this big, you need auto coverage from someone who knows it all. Texas Farm Bureau Insurance, for coverage that's right for how and where you drive in every moment of every mile. Call us, because moments worth covering are never accidents.
At Winkler Place, senior living comes with care and service designed to make your life easier. And now, we're making it even easier to call Winkler Place home with a fall move-in special. Move in by the end of September and you can save on your monthly rental fee. Call 903-694-2525 today to learn how they can help you move in. Or just drop by to tour their apartment homes and see all they have to offer. Winkler Place is located at 513 North Adams Street in Carthage. So start packing. This offer ends soon. Fire and Safety Equipment supports Bulldog football. Look for our new location at 2699 Southeast Loop in Carthage. Open now. We now offer digital fingerprinting, drug and alcohol compliance testing, along with our full line of PPE equipment. We have you covered from head to toe with the best brands, Ariat, Bulwark, Carhartt, Cinch, Wrangler, Rasco, and Walls. Check us out online at TexasFireAndSafety.com. Go Dogs!
Well, we're back here in Palestine. The score is 34-7 and a half. Carthage is ahead. We have no field mics tonight to hear the band. We can't. Sometimes we go to stadiums and we just can't get the field mics to work, and we don't know why, because we're not any further than we are in a lot of those stadiums that are huge that we played in Mansfield and all up in there. But sometimes it just doesn't work out. And so the Carthage band is on the field playing right now facing us. Tell me what y'all have done as far as your contest is concerned.
Oh, well, last weekend we had to host the Area UIL Area C contest in our inside facility. And it was an all-day event. It went from about 8 o'clock in the morning till 10:30. It ended, kind of ended marching about 11:30, and then we were there till 1 o'clock in the morning. But it was definitely a great solution to the rain, because it rained nonstop the entire day. We did work with many of the bands, and of course they have to get that contest done so they can then go to state. And this, I believe, state is this Tuesday. And then this weekend we're gonna have another situation like that, where NAMBI, Texas State Military Marching Contest, hosted by our sponsor by NAMBI, is going to be held at our event, or at our facility again, due to the expected rain. And I do have the list of the bands that are playing this weekend.
All right, let me have.
So we have the Judson Middle School from Longview will be playing at 12:45, and we have Wes Sabine with Director Evan Richardson will be playing at 1:30 p.m. We have Harleton, Director Christy Spears, will be playing at 1:45. Beckville, directed by James Boggs, will be playing at 2:00 p.m. Rhonda Timpson, with Director Rhonda Daniel, will be playing at 2:15. And then we have DeKalb, Director Caitlin Pinheiro, at 2:45. And then we have West Rusk, Director Grady Hafner, at 3:00 p.m. And then we have New Boston, directed by Margie Manning, at 3:15. And then New Diane, directed by George Little, at 3:30 p.m. And then we have Bullard, directed by Gary Jordan. I had this a little bit out of order on my list, but they're going to be playing at 1:00 because they have a conflict. And then Gladewater, directed by Michael Moody, will be going at 4:00. Chapel Hill, directed by Joseph Hewitt, will be going at 4:15. Center, directed by Chris Smith, will be going at 4:30. Henderson, directed by Tommy Moore, will be going at 4:45. Spring Hill, directed by Randy Kaiser, will be going at 5:00. Athens, directed by Rusty Lay, will be going at 5:15. Cleveland, directed by Christy Jones, will be going at 5:30. Brownsboro, directed by Jeff Russell, will be going at 5:45. And Carthage, directed by Nicholas Durham, will be going at 6:00 p.m. Gilmer, directed by Eric Gray, will be going at 6:15. Pittsburgh, directed by Austin Jesmore, will be going at 6:30. Lindale, directed by Stephen Moore, will be going at 7:15. And Lufkin, directed by Scott Williams, will be going at 7:30. And then the Longview Lobo Band is going to be doing an exhibition at 8 o'clock that same evening.
So they have a different type of deal, band?
We were originally going to host the NAMBI was going to be at Lobo Stadium.
Okay.
And so we had to change it to the indoor facility because of the rain.
They said there'd be very little room for people to watch.
There will be, but people who want to see, like friends and family of that band, will be able to see the band that they want to see. So if you have a family member or friends of one of the directors of those bands, we allow people in to see that one band, yeah. And it's free. There's no admission fee this year because of the you can't stay for the whole show.
Well, the reason we use ours is because ours is the biggest one, and it's a full football field length, so y'all can do your whole routine.
Yes.
And if y'all have never been in there, you need to go to school and look at that. That's a really neat place.
It's 100 yards with one end zone.
Mm-hmm. And it's just really nice. And, you know, the band and the baseball, everybody uses that thing. It's in sports.
Yeah,
except maybe for basketball. You know, baseball uses it, and so they have
a grounding practice in there, I guess. So it's really a great facility. We ought to be proud of it.
Well, it's definitely getting used, which is good. So, and now it's getting, I guess, some publicity. Got a lot of publicity last weekend with, it wasn't just our region, it was our area. So it was about 34 bands that were there last weekend.
All right. Well, we'll go back and pay some bills.
Randy Hudson, a 1984 Carthage High School graduate, invites you to stop by their new Carthage branch of the Hudson Financial Group. They offer property and casualty insurance on an independent platform, which allows them to help you with all types of risk. With companies like the Hartford, MassMutual, and Travelers, to name a few, Randy and his dad, Herb, look forward to assisting you with your insurance and financial needs. The Hudson Financial Group, 1507 West Panola in Carthage. Call 903-693-7874.
Pippin Motor Company in Carthage is your authorized GM dealer in Panola County. You will find the best deals anywhere around on Chevrolet, Buick, and Cadillac cars, not to mention Chevrolet and GMC trucks. Pippin Motor Company has a state-of-the-art service department along with a well-trained staff to take care of your every service need. So whether it is sales, service, parts, or just a hot cup of coffee, we are Pippin Motor Company, located right across from Panola College, your full-service GM dealer.
The heat of summer has finally passed, and the next 2 months are a perfect time to get out and enjoy the outdoors. And there's no better place to do just that than Carthage Country Club, located on U.S. Highway 79 North. Carthage Country Club features a 9-hole course, driving range, and full-service bar, where you can relax after a round of golf. Memberships are available, and call about special seasonal pricing, 903-693-9900. Carthage Country Club, proud sponsors of the Carthage Bulldogs.
Well, on your contest that you've been to, tell me what y'all have done in those.
Oh, at the UIL 2 weeks ago, we got straight ones, which is first divisions. So we did very good. That was the only state contest we have this year. And then, of course, we have NAMBI on Saturday where we'll be participating. And that one, you actually do compete for a first place, second place, third place. And there are 11 bands in our conference of 4A, so 11 other bands that we'll be competing against. And we'll also be getting ratings, hopefully make superior ratings, first division ratings the whole time. And then we can't hear the band outside, but definitely can see them. And we have several more than usual students in their football jerseys or their football gear because the junior varsity game was today as well, and they drove down to meet us for the halftime show. And then we also had several more members that joined the varsity team today too.
Oh, is that right?
So you'll see there's about, if you look down, there's about 10 people wearing football uniforms. Three of them are on the varsity, and the seven or so are on the junior varsity. And, of course, we have our twirlers and flags, our auxiliary. And then we have a cheerleader and three students from the bells.
Well, who are your twirlers this year?
Our twirlers this year. The majorettes are led by senior and captain Kelsey Weiner, junior and lieutenant Cassie Tinkle. And the flags are led on the field by senior and captain Macy Isbell, junior and lieutenant Morgan Nicholas, senior and lieutenant Miosha Brown. The other flags are freshman Isabella Burns, junior Ashanti Burrows, senior Kaylee Cooper, freshman Logan Dotson, senior Maria Ewens, sophomore Ivana Hawkins, junior Shantavia Hicks, sophomore Ayanna Jennings, freshman Denijah Leary, senior Gabby Salone, junior Shakitria Sparks, senior Kiara Ware, and freshman Daria Yarbrough.
Score is 34-7 here in Palestine. We're at halftime. We'll be back right after this.
Country at its best. That's our town motto. And part of what makes living here so good is having access to health care that rivals what's available in much bigger cities because ETMC Carthage is right here in the heart of our community. ETMC Carthage, where emergencies are treated around the clock in our Level 4 Trauma Center, where you'll find advanced radiology and imaging technology, specialists in cardiology, internal medicine, family medicine, and much more. It's personalized attention only found in close-knit communities like ours. ETMC Healthcare at its best right here in Carthage.
At Prosperity Bank, you're considered part of our family, so we offer a variety of checking accounts to suit any lifestyle, including a few with no minimum balance requirement. Need teen checking, mobile banking, or hassle-free debit card? Look no further than Prosperity Bank. And if you're in the market for a loan, such as a home equity loan or refinance, we're the bank to call. Your financial future is our focus. Prosperity Bank, member FDIC, equal housing lender. Go Bulldogs!
Okay, you know, we talk about the marching contest and everything, but we never talk about how really active band is. Band really never shuts down. You know, you got a football season that shuts down, but band doesn't. Y'all go to solo, right, ensemble, then you go to concert. How does that work out?
All right, well, as soon as we'll probably start on December, in early December, we have region auditions. So we'll have about 20 or so kids go audition for region band, and then they'll hopefully place and make area, and then the audition for area, and then last year we had one student who made state, so she got to go to San Antonio for the state contest. So that's going on right now, and then right as that starts to end, we have solo and ensemble, which is a individuals pick solos, and then we have small groups of performers, and they can get, that's a UIL event, so they can receive ones, twos, or three ratings on that. And then of course that leads us into our UIL contest and sight reading contest, our concert and sight reading contest, which will be in the spring. It's hard to think that far away, but you're right. We just kind of keep on going. Looks like we're going to have a busy football season with the playoffs coming up.
Hopefully we go 16 games this year. That's what I'm hoping for, because the state championship is in Houston at their stadium.
Hmm.
And so that would be a first. I was lucky enough to do Elysian Fields back when they made their couple of runs. And I did one game in the Astrodome, which is awesome.
Right.
And then I did a couple of games in Texas Stadium, and then now I've done a couple of games in Jerry World. So this year we're moving to Houston. I think it's NRG Stadium or something like that. I've been in the stadium to watch Sam Houston play SFA.
So have I. I've been to a couple of their games too. Yes, Battle of the Pines.
Yeah.
Being a SFA alumni.
See, my two children went to SFA, and I always told them they were academically not good enough to get to Sam Houston where I went. And then we have a kind of a rivalry there. So my son and I, every once in a while, will go down and watch that game. Matter of fact, he got me tickets last year. And they were on the 50-yard line, but on the SFA side. Ah. But that was fine. I mean, we were right down on the field, and it's like five, six rows up. I said, well, how'd you get that? He said, fraternity. Hmm. I said, oh, okay. They keep going, he said.
Well, I wonder if I'll be able to find my way into the press box in time.
I don't know. Yeah. Of course, Jerry will be doing that game if it happens, so he may can handle the band by himself that game. All right, the score is 34-7. Palestine's band's on the field. We have a problem with our field mic, so we'll go back and pay some bills.
It may be hot one day and cold the next, but whatever Mother Nature throws our way, you can always count on a Train heating and cooling system. Hal and Bruce Whitaker at Hal's AC Heating and Electrical are the names to know to keep you in the comfort zone. Whether it's residential, commercial, industrial, or oil field work, Hal's AC Heating and Electrical is the one to call for service on all makes and models. 903-693-7451. That's 693-7451 for Hal's AC Heating and Electrical.
We all like to save money, and State Farm can help with discounts. When you combine your car insurance with your State Farm homeowner's insurance, you get big savings. So talk to me, Agent Tate Barber, and experience the Good Neighbor service that has made us America's number one insurance company. Together, we can help you make sure you get the discount you deserve. No policy with State Farm? No problem. Call me, Agent Tate Barber, at 903-693-7555 or stop by my office, 1502 West Panola, directly across the street from McDonald's, to find out how much a multi-line discount can save you.
For more than 100 years, First State Bank and Trust Company has been a strong, trusted bank the people of Panola County can count on. Today, we are one of the few banks in East Texas to earn a 5-star rating for strength and security from the Premier National Rating Service. Bauer Financial has rated the bank one of the strongest and continues to do so year after year, good times or bad. We're proud of this honor, but are even more proud of the people we serve. To learn more, call, click, or come by. Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender.
There's nothing more pleasant than fall temperatures in East Texas. Evenings that are just right for grilling outdoors. At Bill's Meat Market, they make that outdoor cooking easy. Stop by today and find a 10-pound box of hamburger patties for just $29.99. They also have custom-cut steaks, delicious sausage, and a gourmet food selection. Bill's Meat Market, 1317 West Panola, where you can always find fresh-cut meat. Bill's Carthage.
Panola County football isn't shy, and God says neither should we. The Apostle Paul encouraged his young friend Timothy, "For God did not give us the spirit of timidity, but a spirit of power and of love and of self-discipline." This is Steve Jackson, pastor of Central Baptist Church in Carthage. Share your weekend with us as we worship God and find strength for abundant life this Sunday morning at 10:45.
How many kids are marching tonight?
In our band, we had 112 marching.
112. I think I remember when it was 66 or something like that before Mr. Durham got here.
I believe in Mr. Durham's first year, it was in the 40s.
Oh, was that right?
So the 60s must have been his second year or so.
Okay. All right.
We're expecting to keep on growing about the same rate as we did this year. We should have a big freshman class come in again. So
back years ago, you know, we would go to stadiums and we would win the band. I mean, we had a big 250-member band, and except with the exception of maybe Henderson or Pine Tree, we pretty much would win the band. So we said, we might lose a game, but we're going to win the band.
Well, the bigger you get, it just kind of snowballs. I mean, you get a little bit better. You get a little bit more people who want to be in for friends, the social reasons, and they want to be in because we're successful, so...
I guess retention is really starting them out and keeping them in it, isn't it?
Exactly. That's what you have to do, keep that retention. You got to keep them going. And, of course, you know, sixth grade band is so different from junior high band. And then high school band is so different from junior high band. So to keep them going on, it really works good to have consistency in the teachers. You know, Mr. Durham being around for a while. This is my second year, and we got Mr. Johnson back. So that always helps when we have that consistency with the staff. And hopefully we're having to the point where we're getting good enough we can have a lot of fun, too.
Well, I mean, I'm sure, you know, when you are announced that you got your ones, that was like a winning a football game. I mean, they worked hard. Y'all started back when it was hot, didn't you?
We started back when it was hot. It's about to start getting cold. I remember last year's playoff games. But, yeah, we started off when it was hot. So we've been working on that, and I don't want to say the prize, but we got the goal. We reached our goal. So, and it's a state competition, too. It's a UIL competition. So, I do have some of the officers of our band since we're up here. We have our president is Cole Donnell. Our vice president is Molly Barrow. Our historian is Hannah Villanueva. Our chaplain is Braden Sowell. Our head band manager is Caleb Gibbs. Our quartermasters are Molly Barlow, Sakayla Cooper, Maria Ewens, Jasmine Graves, Asia Ingram. Librarians are Riley Green, Tiffany Nail, and Morgan Nicholas. Drum major is Haley Cloninger. The high school principal, of course, is Mr. Otis Amy. The superintendent of Carthage Schools is Dr. Glenn Hambrick. And, of course, our corporate sponsor for the band is Foley Rentals.
You know, sometimes the ones that never get mentioned are the cheerleaders. You got a copy of the cheerleaders over there?
I do.
We need to mention them. They you don't hear from much from them because they don't have a pep squad anymore like they used to. So two bits, four bits sometimes doesn't get enough recognition. You can't hear them sometimes. So if you would name those girls, they need to be named.
Our Carthage High School cheerleaders of 2015-2016, our co-captain Kristen Martin, who's a senior, our co-captain Reagan Stanley, who is a senior, Morgan Alexander, who's a senior, Tori Goris, who is a senior, Shaniqua Mack, who is a senior, Ali Russo, who is a senior, Caitlin Asher, who's a junior, Taylor Hughes, who is a junior, Savannah Pride, who's a junior, Cassidy Soap, who's a junior, Ashley Thompson, who's a junior, Kylie Tucker, who's a junior, and then, of course, our mascots are Destiny Buffin and Ebony Washington.
And those girls have a rough time to start a year, too. It's heavy and it's hot in those suits, I guarantee you. All right, score's 34-7. We got about 8 minutes left before we start the second half. Bulldogs are ahead. We'll be back after this.
When you buy it in the morning, you will be enjoying it in the afternoon. Because at Carthage Furniture Company, you get delivery the same day. Monty Bacon specials include a sofa and love seat, the price just $6.99, and they are available in red, gray, or dark brown. Monty has two Ashley Rocker recliners for $2.99 each, or two Best Rocker recliners for $2.99 each. Just look through the car wash, and there we are, Carthage Furniture Company, where your comfort counts.
Longhorn Grill in Carthage, country cooking at its best. Stop by Longhorn Grill today and enjoy a country fried steak, catfish, shrimp, tilapia, or maybe even a cheeseburger. Longhorn Grill also serves up the best steak in town, and don't forget those mouth-watering desserts such as country peach cobbler and bourbon bread pudding. Open daily 10:30 a.m. until 10 p.m. with catering and to-go orders available. Longhorn Grill on West Panola, where it's all about the food.
Do you suffer from sleep problems? Sleep apnea is one of the largest growing disease processes nationwide. If you've tried to get help from a doctor or taken part in a sleep study only to find the mask is uncomfortable, then you need to call Cross Medical. Nationwide, about 50% of sleep apnea patients tolerate CPAP therapy, but Cross Medical's average is closer to 90%. Cross Medical staff are experts at fixing those little issues that prevent patients from compliance with therapy. Call Cross Medical, 903-938-2800.
At Panola National Bank, we're constantly looking for ways to make community banking even better. Now we're making it easier for you to bank on the go with Mobile PNB. Our new mobile banking service allows you to access your accounts directly from your cell phone so you can make transfers, check balances, and search transactions all from the convenience of your cell phone or tablet. Be sure to check out our new free mobile apps in the iTunes Store and the Google Play Store. Panola National Bank, member FDIC, and an equal housing lender.
Mr. Hull, have y'all got any thing special for maybe the playoffs? Y'all working on another little routine?
Our big focus is, of course, this weekend, and then I'm sure we'll come up with something to be a little bit different after that. The kids get tired of doing the same show for so long. We space it out with throughout the football season, but by now they're ready to move on to something else.
Usually, y'all put together something a little different, you know.
I know that today the auxiliary and the bells were going to they're doing the routines to Venus. We changed that song this week.
Well, 6 minutes left. Bulldogs are ahead 34-7 here in halftime. The Bulldogs are out warming up and getting ready for the second half, and we'll get Larry in here for his halftime stats right after this.
Back. Time to dust off that backpack, sharpen your pencils, and save big on the most important tool of all, super fast internet. For a limited time, when you get Fidelity's high-speed internet with blazing fast 100 meg download speeds, we'll give you 200 channels of free TV for a year, or choose 20 meg internet for just $29.99 a month for a year. As always, there's no data caps, no contract, and free installation. Call your local Fidelity office today, or order online at fidelitycommunications.com/free TV.
Hunting for your best deal on a new truck? We got you covered at Excel Ford in Carthage. We've got more than 50, you heard me, 50 new Ford F-150s on the lot and on sale right now. Regular cabs, crew cabs, 4x4s, work trucks, we've got them all and all priced low to go. Powerful performance, smooth ride, and huge savings. A Ford truck from Excel Ford delivers. No need to hunt around. You'll find us right on the loop and right on the price at Excel Ford in Carthage. Plus title, tax, and license with approved credit.
Bauer Furniture Company has been in Carthage for over 50 years, providing name brand furniture at affordable prices. Names like Lazy Boy, Mayo, and Serta are found at Bauer. Have you been in Bauer's lately? You will find a huge inventory, over 100 recliners, 70 sofas, 25 dining room suits, a store who takes pride in their community. Here on West Panola in Carthage.
Larry Allen, Mark Harris, and Dustin Burns. We haven't heard much from Dustin that because we've had some technology problems here. Let's take a look now at the scoring in the first half. Most of it by the Bulldogs. The Bulldogs with 5 touchdowns, 8-yard pass from Blissett to McLean, 52-yard run by Keontae Ingram, 56-yard pass from Jared Blissett to Jakeldrick Jackson. 65-yard pass from Blissett to Jackson again. And then a 2-yard run by Ravodney Hardy. The one touchdown for the Palestine Wildcats, a 67-yard run by Irek Dion. And the Bulldogs had, let's see, we missed one kick to the left, had one kick blocked, and then we were good on a 2-point conversion pass from Blissett to Marquise Gwynn. Here's a look at the statistics. Basically, you can sum it up this way. Palestine with a little bit of an edge on the ground, and Carthage with a huge edge through the air. Carthage 12 first downs, and we don't have too many first downs because we've been scoring on some long plays. Palestine with 8 first downs. On the ground, Carthage 85, Palestine 157. I don't think Coach Surratt will be happy with that total, 157 for Palestine on the ground. But through the air, boy, Blissett's been on the mark, 9 of 13 for 218 yards. And incidentally, that's been spread around 5 different receivers. Jackson has 4 receptions for 150, McLean 1 for 8, Townsend 1 for 22, and Gwynn 2 for 17, and Ravodney Hardy 1 for 21. So 5 different receivers tonight for the Bulldogs. Let's see. Again, Blissett 9 of 13 for 218, Palestine 6 of 11 for 36. So the total yardage, Carthage 303, Palestine 193. Each team had one turnover. Penalties in the first half, Carthage 2 for 10, Palestine 7 for 59. Carthage did not punt. Palestine punted twice for a 34-yard average. And again, remember that Carthage can still be the number one seed in the district, but Carthage has to win their final two. Kilgore must lose their final two. Carthage can still be district champs. They've got to win their last two and then hope that Kilgore loses one game. Kilgore tomorrow night will be hosting Brownsboro, senior night for Kilgore in their last home game. And then the last game of the year, as Mark said, you never can tell what's going to happen when you have a big rivalry game. Kilgore goes to Henderson. And remember last year, Kilgore knocked Henderson out of an undisputed district championship. And so this year, Henderson is probably going to have a chance to boot Kilgore out of an undisputed district championship. Again, the Bulldogs leading at halftime 34-7.
This is Mark Harris at Farmer State Bank in Carthage. Did you know Farmer State Bank offers 15, 20, and 30-year fixed-rate mortgages? We will service your loan in-house, and you can make a payment at one of our 5 full-service locations, Center, Main Bank, and Rough Rider Branch, Carthage, Joaquin, Shelbyville. So come by Farmer State Bank, and let us help you buy the home of your dreams. Farmer State Bank, member FDIC, and equal housing lender. Money.
Driving across Texas? Get comfortable. There's nearly 300,000 square miles to explore. In a state this big, you need auto coverage from someone who knows it all. Texas Farm Bureau Insurance, for coverage that's right for how and where you drive and every moment of every mile. Call us, because moments worth covering are never accidents.
For all your insurance needs, come see me, Jenny Morgan, out on the loop in Carthage at Panola County Farm Bureau.
Discounts may vary by situation.
Want to remind you that our stats tonight, and we just gave them to you, made possible by Carthage Flower Shop on the Square in Carthage. Second half kickoff coming up is going to be brought to you by your local Sears store in Carthage. From appliances to lawnmowers, Sears has it all. Well, I told you I was going to tell you the significance of coming back to Wildcat Stadium. Wildcat Stadium, Palestine, this is where Jerry Hansen and I had our first broadcast together back in late August 1988. And then the very next day, a tragic plane crash in Carthage that took the life of Don and Linda Griffith and a Carthage cheerleader and Ann Apple, who was the assistant principal at Carthage High School. They went to Louisiana to watch Todd Griffith play football and came back, and in some bad weather were about 2 miles short of the south end of the runway at Pounds Field. And that was a tragic.
That was Brewster Griffith's grandparents.
That's correct. Saw Todd Griffith, who they went to see play. I saw him at Chalk Talk this past Monday and visited with him about that. Okay, here's a kickoff. It's taken by D. Bowens at the 20-yard line. Bowens up to the 25, 30, little hole, 35, 40, down the near sideline, 50, 45, 40. Cuts back to the middle to the 35, the 30. He may score to the 25, 20, 15, 10, and down at the 10-yard line is D. Bowens after a return of 80 yards.
Wow.
I'm telling you, this kid's going to be a playmaker, and he's just done one just then. Oh, look out. There's a flag back here.
So, I'll be. Well,
and they're going to bring it back.
About an I said 80. I think it was about a 70-yard return. I'll check that. But bring it back, and practically all of it's going to be wiped out. There's a flag back at the 27, so it'll be a 7-yard return, and then they should mark it off half the distance to the goal from the 27. Or it could be a 10-yard penalty. We'll wait and tell you in a moment. It's going to be a 10-yard penalty back to the 17. So Carthage now with 3 penalties for 20 yards. Well, and another significance to tonight's ball game. The third time we've mentioned this. This would be the 100th career win for Coach Surratt if the Bulldogs hold on. Next Friday night, don't forget, last home game of the regular season, Chapel Hill at Bulldog Stadium. Here's the handoff. It goes this time to the running back coming left to the 20, 25. This is Hearn. Hearn out to the 30-yard line. D. Hearn on the run. And Hearn picks up another Garrett's Record Service Bulldog first down, 14 yards for D. Hearn.
And see, I like that because Hunter come in and was quarterback then, and we've always just about run him. And so now we're adding a couple of different wrinkles. They're expecting us to run him when he comes in, but that was a good play around the left end.
Okay, I didn't catch that. Indeed, it is Hunter Townsend at quarterback in the shotgun. And we're going to see him 2 receivers to the right, 2 to the left. Snap back to Townsend. Townsend goes on the quarterback, draw to the 30. Townsend to the 35 and spins away from a tackle at the 35 out to the 38-yard line. 7 yards for Townsend on the quarterback draw.
There's a quarterback draw up the middle, and he had good blocking in front. Here comes Blissett back in the game with Ford Parker and Hardy. So we're going back to our regular offense now.
And in case you've just joined us, we've had some trouble tonight with our contact with Dustin Burns on the sideline. Certainly apologize for that, because we wanted to try to bring you a special presentation from after the game that we think is going to occur. Okay, now let's see. Second down and 3. Second and 3 for Carthage at their 38. Snap back to Blissett. Blissett looking left. Looking left. Great protection. Throws deep left. This is caught by Jackson at the 40-yard line. To the 35. Jackson to the 30. Jackson down to about the 27-yard line. That's going to be another Garrett's Record Service Bulldog first down.
And that puts him close to 200 yards receiving tonight. He had 150 before that.
So that's 12 and then 23. That's 35 yards there. 35 yards. And again, another first down for the Bulldogs. First and 10 now at the 27-yard line. Here's Blissett. Play action fake. Rolls to his right. He throws. This ball is caught there by Ford Parker. And Parker holding on to the football after he was hit hard by a couple of Palestine Wildcats, holds on to it. And he takes it down to the 22 for a 5-yard pickup.
That's that old Harris boy. 9:56 left in the third quarter, 34-7 Carthage.
And so Ford Parker would now be the 1-2-3. That's the 6th different receiver to have receptions tonight for Carthage. Second and 5 at the Palestine 22. Here's a 3-step drop. Blissett under heavy pressure, and he's going to be sacked. Blissett under heavy pressure as he rolled to his left. And that's going to be a loss from the 22 back to the 28, a loss of 6.
Well, that was a coverage sack. You know, we always throw that ball out in the flat to the slot receiver, and he was covered. And so when he went to throw and he pulled up, and they sacked him after that.
So the 6-yard sack brings up 3rd and 11. 3rd and 11 for Carthage at the Palestine 28-yard line. Twin receivers to the left, one to the right. Snap back to Blissett. Blissett looking over the middle. He throws over the middle. This ball is low. That, I think he had Townsend there down at about the 8-yard line, but that was, for some reason, low and into the ground.
I don't know if he lost it or there was just a little bit of a wrong route run, but I got a feeling it was he threw it low because he was open in the middle of the field.
So it's fourth down, fourth and 11 now for the Bulldogs at the Wildcat 28-yard line, 8:57 to play here in the third quarter. So we have taken the opening kickoff of the second half, and we've now held it for 3 minutes and 3 seconds. and picked up some first downs, and we've driven it down to the 28-yard line. Fourth and 11 there. Snap back to Blissett in the gun. He throws over the middle, and this ball is caught at the goal line for a touchdown to Jakeldrick Jackson. That's a touchdown of 28 yards.
Now, that's going to put him over 200 and three touchdowns. What a game for Jakeldrick tonight. He broke the record of a game for the Bulldogs a couple of weeks ago, two or three weeks ago, with 239 yards receiving. Tonight he's got over 200.
So a 28-yard touchdown pass, and the Bulldogs now will attempt the extra point. The Bulldog extra point attempt brought to you by Pretty Paul's Grooming and Boarding. And Jose DeJulian in for the extra point. Here's the kick, and is it good? Yes, it made it inside that left upright. It's now Carthage 41, Palestine 7, 8:52 to play in the third. Back right after this.
At Winkler Place, senior living comes with care and service designed to make your life easier. And now, we're making it even easier to call Winkler Place home with a fall move-in special. Move in by the end of September and you can save on your monthly rental fee. Call 903-694-2525 today to learn how they can help you move in. Or just drop by to tour their apartment homes and see all they have to offer. Winkler Place is located at 513 North Adams Street in Carthage. So start packing. This offer ends soon.
Fire and Safety Equipment supports Bulldog football. Look for our new location at 2699 Southeast Loop in Carthage. Open now. We now offer digital fingerprinting, drug and alcohol compliance testing, along with our full line of PPE equipment. We have you covered from head to toe with the best brands, Ariat, Bulwark, Carhartt, Cinch, Wrangler, Rasco, and Walls. Check us out online at TexasFireAndSafety.com. Go Dogs!
Well, a touchdown pass from Jared McLean to Jakeldrick Jackson. Is that three for them tonight? One, two, three. It is. That's right.
That's how many is for Blizzard tonight? Five?
Let's see. We'll catch that in a second. I think that's at least four. Here's the kickoff. Palestine with it, the 25, the 30, 35. Stopped at the 36-yard line. Let's see. Touchdown passes. One, two, three, four. Three to Jackson and one to McLean.
Okay. 8:43 left here, 41-7 Carthage, clinching at least possibly a second seed. Hopefully that Henderson will return to favor from Kilgore. If Brownsboro's quarterback comes back, that may be a different situation too, because they're both running teams, and so that could be time-consuming runs, long drives, and over with quick.
Okay, 15 yards being marked off here against the Bulldogs. So a biggie there takes it out across midfield for Palestine. They now have it first and 10 on the Carthage 49-yard line. Ball's on the right hash. Palestine going from our left to right here in the third quarter. Snap back to Claude Rogers. Rogers hands off to the running back. And this is going to be the young man that had the long touchdown run, Dion. No gain on the play.
Yeah, we stuffed that up pretty good, the line of scrimmage, interior lineman.
Dion up the middle for no gain. Second down and 10 for the Wildcats at the Bulldog 49-yard line.
Is anybody else playing in our district tonight?
We're the only ones that moved the game.
Okay.
So that means Brownsboro at Kilgore tomorrow night, Henderson and Chapel Hill. I think they're at Chapel Hill. Here's a handoff to Dion, fumble, and we're going to get this one. We tried to pick it up. We do at the 35. It's going to be a touchdown for the Bulldogs. D. Hearn picked it up, and it's going to be a 35-yard fumble return by Hearn for a Carthage touchdown. Carthage leads it now 47-7.
He tried to pick it up, and he fumbled it two or three times. They usually get on, but he was so wide open back there by himself, he had time to stop and pick it up. And then he's got sprinter speed, so they couldn't catch him.
35-yard fumble return by D. Hearn.
I didn't know who was on the tackle on that play, but whoever did disrupted that whole play and hit him by the time he got the ball. And I think it was Perez, but I couldn't tell.
Here's a good snap. The kick by DeJulian is good, and it's now 41-48-7 Carthage after the pretty pause in grooming Bulldog extra point attempt. All right, Carthage up 48-7, 7:55 to play in the third. Back right after this.
Randy Hudson, a 1984 Carthage High School graduate, invites you to stop by their new Carthage branch of the Hudson Financial Group. They offer property and casualty insurance on an independent platform, which allows them to help you with all types of risk. With companies like the Hartford, Mass Mutual, and Travelers, to name a few, Randy and his dad, Herb, look forward to assisting you with your insurance and financial needs. The Hudson Financial Group, 1507 West Panola in Carthage. Call 903-693-7874.
Pippin Motor Company in Carthage is your authorized GM dealer in Panola County. You will find the best deals anywhere around on Chevrolet, Buick, and Cadillac cars, not to mention Chevrolet and GMC trucks. Pippin Motor Company has a state-of-the-art service department along with a well-trained staff to take care of your every service need. So whether it is sales, service, parts, or just a hot cup of coffee, we are Pippin Motor Company, located right across from Panola College, your full-service GM dealer.
Well, a fumble by Palestine, and D. Hearn had about two or three opportunities to pick it up. On the first couple, he sort of muffed it, but then he was so wide open that he had time to pick it up on the third try, and he took it 35 yards for the touchdown. Here's a kickoff to Palestine up to the 10, 15, 20, 25, 30, and stopped at the 34-yard line. Palestine first and 10 at their 33 is where they're going to spot the football.
Cameron Matlock on the tackle, the junior. For the Dogs. Now, we might see some new faces now out here. We're going to slowly start seeing some new faces.
And we may not, fans, we may not get all their names because the JV team is not playing tonight, and I understand they brought the entire JV offensive line for one thing, and we do not have their numbers because they were assigned so late. All right, Palestine with it, first and 10 from their own 33. And here's the quarterback, and this is Mims. Mims for two to the 35, making it second down and eight.
We were on 52 that time, five defensive linemen and two linebackers. We've been working on that, and they're trying to stop that run. Mikhail Gates now is down on the, putting his hand on the ground now rather than being a linebacker. And they seem to think that he's going to turn out to be, that's going to turn out to be his forte.
Second and eight. Second and eight for Palestine at their 35-yard line. Here's Mims faking the handoff. He runs it 35, 40 out across the 45 and 40 to the 46. That's going to be a first down, a gain of make it 12 yards for Mims.
Mason Graham on the tackle. It is 48-7 Carthage. I just wish they'd just run the clock now. We don't need any injuries. We need to come through this game clean. We've, our middle linebacker's out, and one of our defensive linemen's out, and maybe for the year. So,
but good news, the middle linebacker should be back in a few weeks, and boy, we can sure use him. Here's the snap back to Mims. Mims on the run himself and picks up a couple of yards, and I tell you what, I think they're going to be, even though they're down by a big score, I think they're going to be content to run this ball and, you know, shorten the game a little bit.
Gatlin and Brewster on the tackle on that play.
Clock now down to 6:20, so we're getting close to the midway point here in the third quarter. Second down and eight for Palestine at their 49. Carthage up 48-7. 6:10 to play here in the third. Snap back to Mims. Mims hands off to Dion. Dion, the young man with a long touchdown run, and no touchdown run there. It's going to be a loss of three back to the 46.
See who come up out of that pile. I can't see. It's a zero is the last number. And Brewster Griffin was in on the tackle. That was McLean. He and McLean seem to be getting some good tackles together. I've been calling their names on a lot of tackles the last two or three weeks.
And I want to remind you again, the Bulldogs in the regular season next week at home against the Chapel Hill Bulldogs. Senior night. Come out and honor these seniors next week. Third down 11 for Palestine, handoff to Dion. Dion to the 45 midfield, and I think he has a first down. Oh, my. They had third and 11, and they pick up 12 yards.
He sure did. That time they got to the outside, and he cut up field. 5 minutes left here in the third quarter. Clock remains running.
So next week at home at Bulldog Stadium. In 2 weeks, the playoffs start, and it definitely will be at Lufkin's Abe Martin Stadium. We don't know who our opponent will be. We don't know what day we'll play, and we don't probably on Saturday. Don't know for sure what time. It'll be 1 o'clock or 7:30 most likely. Okay, here's the quarterback, Mims, for about 3 yards to the 39.
Foster's favoring the shoulder out there right now. Got a little stinger, looks like.
Okay, Dustin, I assume if you could hear us, you'd be coming in.
Yeah, his mic's on.
Okay. Second and 7 for Palestine at the Carthage 39. We've got 4:25 left to play in the third quarter. Carthage leading 48-7. Second and 7, Palestine at the Dog 39-yard line. Mims takes the shotgun snap and keeps it himself. And that's that quarterback read that we've had some trouble with through the year, some trouble. And a gain of 1 there to the 48 for Mims.
A host of Bulldogs on the tackle. I can't even tell you who was all on it. So many of them around it.
And the clock now under 4 minutes to go.
The moon's full of cheese, Larry, look.
Boy, it sure is. A beautiful night for football here. It was 66 degrees at kickoff. Skies were perfectly clear. Not one cloud in the sky.
That's black rind cheese, that color.
Third and 6. Here's Mims. Mims up the middle across the 35, and I think he has another first down at the 32.
He does. He hadn't waved it over yet. Now he's waving it over.
Okay, so that'll be a gain of 6 more for Mims. And the clock starts up again. And we're now down to 3:15 to play here in the third quarter. Carthage leading at 48-7. Again, next week at home against Chapel Hill. And in 2 weeks, the playoffs start in Lufkin against one of 4 teams from District 10. Jasper, Sealsby, Huffman Hargrave, and one other I can't think of right now. Okay, here's Mims going to the right.
Bridge City.
Bridge City, thank you. And Mims across the 30. And he has, I believe, the 28-yard line, a gain of 4 for Mims. And Jasper leading that district. The other three are now 3-1.
But Jasper has not played the two tough opponents, right? They've played the weaker so far.
They've got two of those. They've got two tough opponents to play, including tomorrow night, Huffman Hargrave at Jasper. Then they go to Sealsby the following week. So it could be one of 4 teams that will be playing in the first round. All right, so now it's, let's see, we've got 2:20 to go in the third quarter. Mims in the shotgun. Snap back to him. Mims goes left side. Mims to the 35. Mims has a, let's see, he's the 20 to the 23. Going to be short of the first down by 1 yard.
And it was Mason Graham on the tackle. Mason Graham is a junior.
1:57 to go in the third quarter. Carthage leading at 48-7. And Palestine just grinding it out here on this drive on the ground.
Against our number one defense.
Yep, that's right. And taking a lot of time off the clock.
Well, that's good.
Third down and 1. Mims keeps it after the fake to the running back. And he has a first down across the 20. And let's see, they're going to give him, I think, the 19. Okay, gain of 4 yards for Mims.
Well, we had one on the shoe off. He's coming out of the game. We're putting a few new faces in the game. 47's in the game. The kicker.
Okay, that'd be, unless we have 247, that's DeJulian.
I heard he hit you. That's what I heard.
Oh, yes, he is a linebacker. That's right, from the JV. And Coach Surratt said a good linebacker. First and 10 for Palestine from the Carthage 19. And let's see, what do we have?
Timeout.
All right.
The heat of summer has finally passed, and the next 2 months are a perfect time to get out and enjoy the outdoors. And there's no better place to do just that than Carthage Country Club, located on U.S. Highway 79 North. Carthage Country Club features a 9-hole course, driving range, and full-service bar, where you can relax after a round of golf. Memberships are available, and call about special seasonal pricing, 903-693-9900. Carthage Country Club, proud sponsors of the Carthage Bulldogs.
country at its best. That's our town motto. And part of what makes living here so good is having access to health care that rivals what's available in much bigger cities, because ETMC Carthage is right here in the heart of our community. ETMC Carthage, where emergencies are treated around the clock, and our Level 4 Trauma Center, where you'll find advanced radiology and imaging technology, specialists in cardiology, internal medicine, family medicine, and much more. It's personalized attention only found in close-knit communities like ours. ETMC Healthcare at its best right here in Carthage.
All right, we're back at Wildcat Stadium. Larry Allen, Dustin Burns, and Mark Harris bringing you Carthage Bulldog football. The Carthage Bulldogs and the Palestine Wildcats. Carthage leading 48-7, 51 seconds left to play in the third quarter. And again, I want to encourage you, next Friday night at home, it'll be senior night against the Chapel Hill Wildcats. First and 10 for Palestine at the Carthage 19. And here is the running back going to his right. This is Dion. That's the young man who had the long touchdown run. He's across the 15 down to the 13. Gain of 6 on the play.
He's tackled by Brad West. He's a senior. Got a few new people coming in new.
And 30 seconds left in the quarter here. So this, unless they pick up a first down or we have an incomplete pass, this will probably be the final play of the third quarter. Mims again in the shotgun. Ball on the right hash. And let's see, handoff to Dion. Dion across the 10. Dion to the 5. Dion down close to the end zone. Is he in? No, he's not. He's short. That's going to be a pickup from the 13 to the 1. A gain of 12 for Dion. A first and goal for Palestine inside the Carthage 1-yard line.
6 seconds left in the third quarter. And hopefully they'll just let this run off. And they are. That's the end of the third quarter. 48-7 Carthage. We'll be back for the fourth quarter after this.
At Prosperity Bank, you're considered part of our family, so we offer a variety of checking accounts to suit any lifestyle, including a few with no minimum balance requirement. Need teen checking, mobile banking, or hassle-free debit card? Look no further than Prosperity Bank. And if you're in the market for a loan, such as a home equity loan or refinance, we're the bank to call. Your financial future is our focus. Prosperity Bank, member FDIC, equal housing lender. Go Bulldogs!
It may be hot one day and cold the next, but whatever Mother Nature throws our way, you can always count on a Train heating and cooling system. Howell and Bruce Whitaker at Howell's AC Heating and Electrical are the names to know to keep you in the comfort zone. Whether it's residential, commercial, industrial, or oil field work, Howell's AC Heating and Electrical is the one to call for service on all makes and models. 903-693-7451. That's 693-7451 for Howell's AC Heating and Electrical.
All right, we have 12 minutes of football remaining here in Palestine. Carthage leading 48-7. And, Mark, you know, you brought up the fact that Jakeldrick Jackson this year earlier already broke Jalen Claiborne's game record for yards receiving in one game. I know Claiborne's record was 199. I did not write down what Jackson was. It was it 229?
239, I believe.
239. Okay, well, he's got 213 right now. All right, 12 minutes to go. First and goal, Palestine at the Carthage 1, actually inside the 1. Snap back to Mims. Mims over the left side. I think he's untouched. Touchdown, Palestine. That took 4 seconds off the clock. We got 11:56 to go in the fourth quarter. That's going to make it 48-13.
Well, if I was coaching, Jakeldrick's night would be over. Bless it. A bunch of them it'd be over with because you've got such a commanding lead. And you're trying to get to the playoffs healthy, and hopefully we get our middle linebacker back. And so we ought to be completely healthy, other than Jalen Lewis. And I understand Jalen's had an MRI today, so I don't know what happened in the MRI. But he was a force in the middle. He was huge, 295 pounds, and he was hard to block. Just hope they let the clock run in this quarter. We can get back to Carthage. A long way back. Got work tomorrow.
Yep. All right. The extra point coming up. There's a snap. Ball's on the tee. Flag on the play. Kick is away. It's good, but there's a flag. Let's see what this is about.
Let's see if he picks it up.
All right, it's against Carthage.
All right. We'll be back after this.
We all like to save money, and State Farm can help with discounts. When you combine your car insurance with your State Farm homeowner's insurance, you get big savings. So talk to me, Agent Tate Barber, and experience the Good Neighbor service that has made us America's number one insurance company. Together, we can help you make sure you get the discount you deserve. No policy with State Farm? No problem. Call me, Agent Tate Barber, at 903-693-7555 or stop by my office, 1502 West Panola, directly across the street from McDonald's, to find out how much a multi-line discount can save you.
For more than 100 years, First State Bank and Trust Company has been a strong, trusted bank the people of Panola County can count on. Today, we are one of the few banks in East Texas to earn a 5-star rating for strength and security from the Premier National Rating Service. Bauer Financial has rated the bank one of the strongest and continues to do so year after year, good times or bad. We're proud of this honor, but are even more proud of the people we serve. To learn more, call, click, or come by. Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender.
11:55 to go in the fourth quarter. Carthage leading 48-14 following the one-yard run by Mims for Palestine. And here's the Palestine kickoff. It's going to come to the near side, taken at the 10-yard line. Back up to the 15, the 20, 25, and out of bounds at about the 26. And that is Colbert. Mekhi Colbert.
I think I see the Davis boy coming in the quarterback. A lot of new fat. No, a lot of new numbers over there. We don't even have them, I don't think. Well, maybe we'll be lucky enough to have a couple of them.
All right, 11:48 to go. And, again, we're glad that you joined us for Bulldog football. A smaller-than-usual crowd for both Carthage and Palestine tonight because it is a Thursday night game. Carthage 7th and 8th graders and 9th grade playing back at Bulldog Stadium tonight. Okay, here's Kaysen Davis pitching out to, let's see, who is that going to the left? And it's going to be a gain from the 26 out to about the 32-yard line. Gain of 6. Who was that?
Let me see. I thought it was 29, but I couldn't tell. Still can't tell. He's back in the huddle. It's 29, okay. But... I have 29 is Montario Wilson, a sophomore.
Okay, I show Keith Brown, a junior.
Okay.
Well, I tell you, I'm...
Well, we might have suited up a couple of numbers and not the same since we had so many we brought, you know.
Okay, so it's second down and 4 now from the 32. Kaysen Davis in there at quarterback, and here's a flag. This is going to be a false start against Carthage.
I also have a number 51 in there.
And I'm afraid that's going to be one of those linemen that, you
Austin
know, again.
Gray.
That's, oh, have you got it there?
It shows here, Austin Gray, a sophomore.
Okay. Austin. Okay, well, I guess you've got the updated roster then, and of then, including the JV bunch.
56 is Hunter Gogger, a sophomore.
Okay.
He's in the offensive line.
So it's now second down and 9. Snap back to Davis. Davis going to throw left, and this one's caught out there. That's going to be a gain of about 4 yards to the 31.
And that was caught by Bowens. 10 minutes
Bowens.
Left.
10 minutes, okay.
48-14 Dogs.
So it's third down and five for Carthage at the Carthage 36-yard line. Bulldogs leading at 48-14 over the Palestine Wildcats. So the Carthage is going to go 6-3 for the season, 3-1 in district play, and probably will be the number 2 seed in the district. Here's a snap back to Davis. Davis looking right. He's throwing right. This ball is caught by Callaway. Callaway at the 38 to the 40, and he is pushed out of bounds. That's going to be another Garrett's Record Service Bulldog first down. It goes from the 31 to the 42. That is a gain of 11 yards.
And they're letting the clock run. 9:25 left, 48-14. You know, Davis came in, and when Blissett went down, threw a big touchdown pass the first time he quarterback. So he's a junior, and his dad's the offensive coordinator, so you know he knows the offense.
That's the 7th different receiver tonight for the Bulldogs. Spreading it around pretty good. Ball on the 42-yard line. And here's the running back going left, and he gains about
a yard.
Yep. picked up about a yard to the 43.
All right, number 27 is coming into the game. Spielman. We've called his name. He ran last week when we got way ahead.
So second and nine now. Second and nine for Carthage from the 43. And, again, we apologize. We don't have Dustin Burns tonight because of a problem from a technological standpoint. Second and nine. Here's Davis. Davis hands off to the tailback, and that's going to be a gain across the 45 to the 47. So a gain of four more. Clock now down to 8:15 and counting.
Jatavion Spielman on that carry. He came in 1 week and had a pretty good amount of yards rushing, like 50 or 60 yards. All kinds of new faces in there.
Third down and five. Okay, let's see if I can spot some of those linemen.
Nolan Griffin's in there, 78, a senior.
52. Who's that?
52.
That's the center.
It's James Ebarb.
Okay. Third down and five. Snap back to Davis. Davis looking right. He's throwing right. This ball is caught by Callaway, and then he's wrapped up immediately. That's going to be a loss of a couple of yards on that pass play.
He didn't get, lead him right. He had him kind of in a bad position, so he was facing the quarterback, and the defender had a chance to get there right as the ball got there.
Okay, they spotted for a loss of one. So it's fourth and six now. Fourth and six for Carthage at our 46-yard line. 7:14 left to play in the ball game. Davis going to be in the shotgun to take this snap. Fourth and six. Snap back to Kaysen. Kaysen looking over the middle. He throws over the middle. This ball is caught for a first down. Big first down throw by Kaysen Davis. Another Garrett's Record Service Bulldog first down.
That was old Bowens again. He just shines whenever you get him the ball in his hands. That's a good pass, too. Good timing pattern there by Davis.
That's a 22-yard gain on to Bowens.
45 entered the ball game. Kerryon Lewis.
That's the eighth different receiver tonight. 6:35 left to go in the ball game. Bulldog first down at the Palestine 32. Handoff goes to Spielman. Spielman left side to the 30. Spielman for four down to the 28-yard line.
You know, for a number of years, we had our football team was so dominant that our starters hardly played the second half. If Dwight Smith would have played the second half of most of his ball games, he'd have led Texas and probably had the record for the year in yardage, and so would Anthony Morgan. But they sit on the bench most of the time because we were so far ahead.
Second down and six now. Second and six for Carthage at the Palestine 28. Kaysen Davis, the quarterback, he's going to go under center. Got a wide out to each side, a wing on the left side. Here's Davis, handoff to Spielman again. I think that's that may not be Spielman. He has spun around for a loss of about 3 yards. Who's number 29 there?
Number 29, I got is Montario Wilson, the sophomore.
Okay. Well, I've got to get that updated roster. I just did not get that. All these guys were added when the JV game was called off yesterday. Called off rather late. And as it turns out, the JV game was not called off because of bad weather. Coach Surratt indicating to me that Palestine probably would not have fielded a JV team, so Palestine would have called it off. That's the reason they didn't have a JV game. 5:10 to go in the ball game. It's 3rd and 9 for Carthage from the Palestine 31. Kaysen Davis in the shotgun. Snap back to him. Davis looking to go with the screen to the left side. It's complete to Wilson to the 30, 25. Wilson to the 24-yard line. He's going to be short of the first down, but it is a gain of 7 yards on the pass play.
There's a flag, but I'm wondering who's on. They let the play run, so it's not a false start. Well, it's called a false start on us. I don't know why they let the play run.
Okay, so that will take it back now to the 36-yard line.
Clock still running.
Okay,
four,
good.
Four and a half left.
That away, guys. Let her go.
We're going to get out of here by 9:30.
Yep. That would be nice. Third down now. Third down and 14 for Carthage at the Palestine 36-yard line, and Palestine asked for a timeout. We'll take a break.
There's nothing more pleasant than fall temperatures in East Texas. Evenings that are just right for grilling outdoors. At Bill's Meat Market, they make that outdoor cooking easy. Stop by today and find a 10-pound box of hamburger patties for just $29.99. They also have custom-cut steaks, delicious sausage, and a gourmet food selection. Bill's Meat Market, 1317 West Panola, where you can always find fresh-cut meat. Bill's Carthage.
Panola County football isn't shy, and God says neither should we. The Apostle Paul encouraged his young friend Timothy, "For God did not give us the spirit of timidity, but a spirit of power and of love and of self-discipline." This is Steve Jackson, pastor of Central Baptist Church in Carthage. Share your weekend with us as we worship God and find strength for abundant life this Sunday morning at 10:45.
All right, we're back at Palestine, Texas, the Wildcat Stadium here at Palestine High School. And this is District 9 4A and Division 1 Class 4A. The district ball game between the Palestine Wildcats and the Carthage Bulldogs. Third down and 14 for Carthage at the Palestine 36. Kaysen Davis in the shotgun. Snap back to him. And he hands off to the running back. I think this is Wilson. Wilson coming right to the 35, 30, 25. Flag on the play. And he has stopped at about the 23-yard line. Going to be just short of the first down, but it's going to be holding against Carthage.
Yeah, they're going to march it back.
Well, game was really rolling along there, running some time off the clock, but a couple of penalties against Carthage, and this is going to...
Last time in the penalty, they let the clock run. 4:19 left, 48-14 Dogs.
Okay, 10-yard penalty. It was from where the infraction occurred, it was a 4-yard running gain on the ground and then 10-yard penalty. So now it's third and a very long, third and 20 for Carthage, and here's a flag.
Is that a legal substitution? We had so many guys coming in and off. Yes.
Okay.
Trying to get these kids in and out, get them a little playing time and confusion on how many or who's supposed to be on the field right now.
Again, reminder that next Friday night we'll be at home, Bulldog Stadium, senior night against the Chapel Hill Bulldogs. Ends the regular season. Come out and honor the seniors. And then in 2 weeks, the playoffs will start in Lufkin against an undetermined team right now from District 10. All right, it's now third and 25. Third and 25 for the Bulldogs from the Palestine 47. Davis in the shotgun. 1 second on the play clock, and we have to call a timeout to avoid a delay of game. Timeout called by Carthage, 3:37 to go. We'll take a break here.
When you buy it in the morning, you will be enjoying it in the afternoon. Because at Carthage Furniture Company, you get delivery the same day. Monty Bacon specials include a sofa and love seat, the price just $6.99, and they are available in red, gray, or dark brown. Monty has two Ashley Rocker recliners for $2.99 each, or two Best Rocker recliners for $2.99 each. Just look through the car wash, and there we are, Carthage Furniture Company, where your comfort counts.
Who got the most real estate tonight in receiving yards is brought to you by Century 21 and Mark Harris. Do you need a house? Do you need some land? Do you need to buy a building? Call me, Mark Harris, at Century 21. 693-5261 is the office, and 903-692-3836. And the most real estate gain tonight is in receiving is Jakeldrick Jackson with 213 yards receiving. He already has the most real estate in East Texas. Brought to you by Mark Harris in Century 21.
Third down now for Carthage. Third down and 25. Third and 25 from the Palestine 47. We've got to get all the way down to the Palestine 22 for a first down. All right, Davis going to be in the shotgun. Two receivers left, two to the right. Snap back to Davis. Davis looking right, going deep right for Callaway. And this ball is incomplete down at the 3-yard line.
He looked like he didn't really go out for that ball, but 3:29 left in the ball game. The clock stops, and we have a fourth down now.
All right, fourth and 25. Carthage up 48-14, and they're going to start the clock again. Two receivers to each side for Carthage. Davis again in the shotgun. Snap back to him. Hand off to the running back. And this is Wilson. And he picks up 3 yards. And that will turn it over on downs to the Palestine Wildcats. So Palestine will get it now at their own 44-yard line.
We'll be 3-1 in district. Hoping for a little help from Henderson and Brownsboro. But and it's very important where you're seated. You know, if you're first place, you get the fourth place team of the district. And I guess if you're second place, you get the third.
That's correct. Okay, we'll talk about that after this next play right here. Yeah, the seeding is important. Mark is right. If you're first, you play a fourth place team. If you're second, you play a third place team. If you're third, you play a second place team. If you're fourth, you play the first place team. All right, here's the handoff. It goes to the running back with the long run, and he is stopped for a one-yard gain, a one-yard loss. Now, another thing, if you're the number one seed, you will not see another number one seed until the third game. If you're a second or third place team, as we were last year, you can see a number one seed in the second game. If you're the fourth seed, you're going to see a number one seed in the first game. So, yeah, the UIL has it right this time. You know, they reward the higher seeds. Here's the run by Mims, and he is brought down for a one-yard gain.
And that's the kicker we're talking about, and he's got it like he's hurt his arm. 2:16 left. Clock remains running. Bulldogs have this in hand.
Okay, third down and 10. 2 minutes. 2 minutes left to go in this one.
No matter how you seed, where would we hit Kilgore again if Kilgore?
Okay, great question. It could not be until the fourth round.
Okay.
Right. Okay. Could not be until the fourth round if. Okay, here is going to be a throw down the field, and it's going to be caught at the 30, 25, 20, 15, and down at the 10-yard line. That's going to be a long pass completion for the Palestine Wildcats.
That's the longest about to play other than run all night.
Okay, that's a 41-7. That's a 48-yard pass completion, 48 yards. And a first down for Palestine. They've got it first and goal now at the Carthage 9-yard line. First and goal at the 9. A minute 20 to go.
They better hurry and get to the line. They're going to get the penalty here.
4 seconds on the play clock. 3, 2, 1. Snap to Mims. Mims rolling right, throwing right. This ball is incomplete in the end zone. Minute 8 to go.
He overthrew him. He was being pressured. Had to get rid of it earlier than he wanted to.
All right, again, please make plans, if you can, to come out to Bulldog Stadium next week and support the seniors as they are honored. They'll be introduced, and, of course, their parents or guardians. And that includes not only the football players, but
cheerleaders.
Cheerleaders, that's right.
The bells.
Yep, and the senior band members at halftime. The bells, that's right. Okay, here's a handoff. It goes to the running back, and he is – out of bounds. Let's see if they keep the clock running. That's going to be a gain there to the 8, a gain of 1 yard.
Clock remains stopped at 1 minute. I thought he brought him down before he got out of bounds, but I guess not.
So now it's third down and goal. Third and goal with 60 seconds to go in the ball game. Third and goal for Palestine from the Carthage 8-yard line. Snap back to Mims. Mims rolling to the right, and he's to the 5, inside the 5, down to about the 1. Gain of 7 for Mims.
And they call the timeout? Surely not.
Yes, they did.
All right, we'll be back after this.
Longhorn Grill in Carthage, country cooking at its best. Stop by Longhorn Grill today and enjoy a country fried steak, catfish, shrimp, tilapia, or maybe even a cheeseburger. Longhorn Grill also serves up the best steak in town, and don't forget those mouth-watering desserts such as country peach cobbler and bourbon bread pudding.
Open daily 10:30 a.m. until 10 p.m. with catering and to-go orders available. Longhorn Grill on West Panola, where it's all about the food.
Do you suffer from sleep problems? Sleep apnea is one of the largest growing disease processes nationwide. If you've tried to get help from a doctor or taken part in a sleep study only to find the mask is uncomfortable, then you need to call Cross Medical. Nationwide, about 50% of sleep apnea patients tolerate CPAP therapy, but Cross Medical's average is closer to 90%. Cross Medical staff are experts at fixing those little issues that prevent patients from compliance with therapy. Call Cross Medical, 903-938-2800.
All right, 48 seconds left to play in the fourth quarter. Carthage leading the Palestine Wildcats 48-14. Palestine is going to have it now fourth and goal from the one. Snap back coming to Mims in a second. And the shotgun, he's got it. And we've got a flag. Flag stops the play, so this is going to be a false start against Palestine. No, it's offside against Carthage. So half the distance to the goal. Usually that goes against the offense, but not this time. Fourth and goal from inside the one. About a foot inside the one. So about 2 feet away for the score for the Palestine Wildcats. It's fourth and goal from the one-yard line. Carthage leading at 48-14. Mims going to be in the shotgun. And the snap back to him, runs into his blocker, and that disrupts the play, and he's going to be brought down short of the goal line. The ball comes out. It's in the end zone. And let's see, they're going to say the play is down. Oh, no, it's a touchback. It's a touchback. They're going to rule it that. No, I don't know for sure it's going to be ruled a touchback. One official said touchback, but there is one official also that's saying it's going to be just inside the one-yard line. So Mims stopped short of the goal line, and Carthage is going to have it first and 10 from about a foot away from the goal line. Mims stopped by the Carthage defense. He ran into his blocker.
He did.
And that's what disrupted the whole play, or he might have scored. And then the ball eventually came loose, but they said he was down. So Carthage is going to have to run one play now. 38 seconds to go in the ball game, and we'll just try to gouge it out and make sure it's not a safety. Quarterback sneak. And we gain about a yard or so. And that's going to be it.
Sure is. Carthage Bulldogs going to go 6-3 on the year. And the clock's running down with 20 seconds left. This is KGAS. We'll be back with Larry's wrap-up in a few minutes.
At Panola National Bank, we're constantly looking for ways to make community banking even better. Now we're making it easier for you to bank on the go with Mobile PNB. Our new mobile banking service allows you to access your accounts directly from your cell phone so you can make transfers, check balances, and search transactions all from the convenience of your cell phone or tablet. Be sure to check out our new free mobile apps in the iTunes Store and the Google Play Store. Panola National Bank, member FDIC, and an equal housing lender.
School's back. Dust off that backpack, sharpen your pencils, and save big on the most important tool of all, super fast internet. For a limited time, when you get Fidelity's high-speed internet with blazing fast 100 meg download speeds, we'll give you 200 channels of free TV for a year, or choose 20 meg internet for just $29.99 a month for a year. As always, there's no data caps, no contract, and free installation. Call your local Fidelity office today or order online at fidelitycommunications.com/free TV.
Hunting for your best deal on a new truck? We got you covered at Excel Ford in Carthage. We've got more than 50, you heard me, 50 new Ford F-150s on the lot and on sale right now. Regular cabs, crew cabs, 4x4s, work trucks, we've got them all and all priced low to go. Powerful performance, smooth ride, and huge savings. A Ford truck from Excel Ford delivers. No need to hunt around. You'll find us right on the loop and right on the price at Excel Ford in Carthage. Plus title, tax, and license with approved credit.
Bauer Furniture Company has been in Carthage for over 50 years, providing name brand furniture at affordable prices. Names like Lazy Boy, Mayo, and Serta are found at Bauer. Have you been in Bauer's lately? you will find a huge inventory. Over 100 recliners, 70 sofas, 25 dining room suites, a store who takes pride in their community. Here on West Panola in Carthage.
This is Mark Harris at Farmer State Bank in Carthage. Did you know Farmer State Bank offers 15, 20, and 30-year fixed-rate mortgages? We will service your loan in-house, and you can make a payment at one of our five full-service locations, Center, Main Bank, and Rough Rider Branch, Carthage, Joaquin, Shelbyville. So come by Farmer State Bank, and let us help you buy the home of your dreams. Farmer State Bank, member FDIC, and equal housing lender. Money.
Friday night at Wildcat Stadium in Palestine, Texas, the Carthage Bulldogs defeated the Palestine Wildcats. The final score was 48-14. Well, let's just give you the Carthage scoring because there was a lot of touchdowns in the ballgame. We won't include the details of when the scores occurred. Here's the scores for the Bulldogs in the ballgame. 8-yard touchdown pass from Blissett to Jared McLean. A 52-yard run by Keontae Ingram. 56-yard pass from Blissett to Jakeldrick Jackson, and then a 65-yard pass from Blissett to Jakeldrick Jackson again, and a 2-yard run by Verrodney Hardy. 5 touchdowns for Carthage in the first half. The only score for Palestine in the first half was a 67-yard run by Irek Dion, and the score at halftime was Carthage 34 and Palestine 7. In the second half, the Bulldogs added 2 more touchdowns, a 28-yard pass from Blissett to Jakeldrick Jackson. So if you're keeping track there, that would be 3 times that Blissett connected with Jakeldrick Jackson on scoring tosses. Also, a 35-yard fumble return for D. Hearn for a touchdown. And the touchdown for the Palestine Wildcats in the second half was a 1-yard run by Devontae Mims. And Carthage wins at 48-14. Here's a look at the statistics in the ball game. Carthage with 17 first downs, Palestine with 15. Carthage 120 yards on the ground, Palestine 216. Carthage through the air 16 of 22 for 372 yards. And incidentally, of those 372 yards, Jakeldrick Jackson had over half of them. Jackson with 6 receptions for 213 yards on Thursday night. And the Palestine Wildcats, 7 of 13 for 84 yards. The total yardage, Carthage 492, Palestine 300. Turnovers in the ball game, Carthage had 1, Palestine 2. Penalties, Carthage 8 for 60 yards, Palestine 7 for 59. Palestine punted twice for a 34-yard average. The Palestine Wildcats are now 1-8 for the season. They are 0-4 in District 9-4A Division 1. The Carthage Bulldogs are 6-3 for the season, and their district record is 3-1 in District 9-4A Division 1. And incidentally, this is the 100th career victory for Scott Surratt at Carthage High School. Reaches the 100 victory mark in his 9th season as the head coach of the Carthage Bulldogs. We invite you to come back next week to Bulldog Stadium for the last regular season game of the year, as the Bulldogs will be hosting the Chapel Hill Bulldogs. Once again, your final score Thursday night from Wildcat Stadium in Palestine, Texas, the Carthage Bulldogs 48 and the Palestine Wildcats 14. For your Sports Beat station, I'm Larry Allen.
You've been listening to Carthage Bulldog Football on KGAS. Our broadcast is made possible in part by East Texas Medical Center Carthage, Prosperity Bank, Howell's AC, State Farm agent Tate Barber, and Pippin Motor Company. Other sponsors making our broadcast possible include the First State Bank and Trust Company, Bill's Meat Market, Carthage Furniture, the Longhorn Grill, and Panola National Bank. Our video replay of tonight's game can be seen on Carthage Cable Channel 18 on Saturday morning beginning at 8:30 a.m. Or you can view the video stream anytime at easttexastoday.com. Other sponsors making our broadcast possible include Fidelity Communications, Central Baptist Church of Carthage, XL Ford, Bauer Furniture Company, and Fire and Safety Equipment. Now be sure and tune in to the East Texas Scoreboard Show. It's coming up next here on KGAS. And thanks to these sponsors, Farmer State Bank, Texas Farm Bureau, Carthage Automotive Tire Plus, and the Hudson Financial Group. Have a great evening, everyone.